Jay Schrader's mission is to reactivate the Raiders' big play offense. In last week's opener, he wasted little time finding Willie Gault with his 53-yard bomb. Steve Berline replaced an injured Schrader in the second series, and the long ball barrage continued as sprinter Willie Gault had his finest day for the silver and black. Is the Raiders' big play offense back in business? We'll find out today as they face the new-look Kansas City Chiefs under Marty Schottenheimer. Marty inherited the NFL's top pass defense, led by six-time Pro Bowler number 20, Daron Cherry. And last week in Denver, they were up to their old tricks as All-Pro Albert Lewis, number 29, thwarted a John Elway threat. And number 52, Angelo Snipes, followed suit later in the game. Today, the reborn Raider big play offense will be challenged by a proud, tough, and tenacious Kansas City defense.
NBC Sports presents the National Football League. Today, it's the Los Angeles Raiders versus the Kansas City Chiefs.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Arrowhead Stadium, a sellout crowd, the largest crowd since 1972. More than 78,000 fans are expected here today, and the weather is absolutely perfect. Not a cloud in the sky, and the temperature in the mid-70s. Hello, everybody. I'm Charlie Jones, along with Merlin Olsen, and this something has got to be going on with you, because Merlin called me in my room at 6 o'clock this morning, and he says, are you ready?
No, Charlie, you're right. Ever since I got bitten by the football bug as a very young man, there's always been one day in the fall when the temperature and the crowd and the colors and the noise said, football season is here. Today's that day for me.
It is here. And for the Raiders, the big play is here. And they bombed San Diego last week in the Coliseum. What's their secret to going deep?
Charlie, I think last week, Willie Gault's speed didn't hurt at all. But the real key was Marcus Allen. He came back. They put him in the lineup. They ran the ball effectively. They pulled San Diego's defense in, and they threw the ball over the top.
And what do you expect from the Raiders today?
I expect more of the same, and Marcus is going to have his hands full. They're going to give him the football here today.
All right, on the other side, what does Kansas City have to do?
Kansas City is even more dependent on the running game than are the Raiders. The reason, they're a ball control offense. Their first choice, to run the football. Their second choice, play action passing, which only works if you're running well. And their final choice, third choice, is drop back passing.
So that means that Christian Okoye, the running back, will have to carry the load.
And Okoye has had problems. Early in the training camp, he went down with a pinched nerve in his neck. His hands went numb. And they were very careful in bringing him back. In fact, they only got him back to practicing 10 days ago. So he has not had many games. He has not played a lot. But they are still expecting big things from him today.
So Marcus Allen, Christian Okoye, two of the keys, the running backs. Who is the running back's best friend?
If you're going to run the football, you must control the line of scrimmage. And that means that the center, the quarterback of that offensive line, has to play well. The Raiders lost their starting center, Don Mosbar. He tore a ligament in his knee. That's a partial tear. They're hoping he'll be back soon. But right now, they've got a young man in there starting that they picked up on free agency. Off of waivers, Dan Turk, number 67. Tremendous pressure on his shoulders today, especially since you've got a rookie, Steve Wisniewski, starting right next to him in that offensive line.
And so that's part of the drama that we'll have unfolding here today at Arrowhead Stadium. Kansas City will be receiving, and that means that Jeff Jaeger will be kicking off for the Los Angeles Raiders. Kenny Gamble, number 22, and Danny Copeland, number 25, are the return men. And the crowd on their feet. Gamble on the far side and Copeland on the near side. And it is Gamble at the set. Turns to the 20-yard line, 12 yards on the return. Now, for the Kansas City offense, that offensive line, the veteran, 16 years in the NFL, Mike Webster, is the center. He told us this is his most challenging season. Now let's look at the Kansas City backs and receivers. They will open with one running back, and that's Christian Okoye, and two tight ends. So when Kansas City goes to four wide receivers, Okoye will come out. The tight ends will come out. Herman Hurd will come in along with Rob Thomas and Naz Werther. And here's Okoye. As he opens it up, and he will pick up about 4 yards, it'll be second down and six. The Raiders defense, their front seven. The change here from last week, Emmanuel King is starting at outside linebacker, replacing Otis Wilson, who was cut. Now, when the Raiders go to their nickel package, their two inside linebackers will come out. Mike Haynes and Eddie Anderson will come in. In the Raiders' secondary, look for the great speed on the corners, Terry McDaniel and Lionel Washington. City staying on the ground, a pick of a three. This time it is James Saxon who is carrying, and Bob Golic, the nose tackle, is the man who brings him down.
Talking to the coaches yesterday, Charlie, the sun is extremely bright bearing down on this stadium, and I think both coaches actually hoped that they would lose the toss so they could select the side of the field and put the sun in the eyes of the receivers, not only the offensive receivers, but also someone dropping back to receive a punt or a kickoff. Kansas City won the toss, elected to take the football, but they're going to have trouble with the sun here early.
And now Kansas City goes with four wide receivers, and they show it out of the shotgun. DeBerg has protection. He throws it there. First down. Rob Thomas, 8 yards. A little bit different start for DeBerg than last week. His first pass was intercepted. His second offensive play was fumbled. Pittman recovered it. And we'll come back to that story. Let's go to the Raiders.
Let's take a peek at Rob Thomas and see how he got room there. Of course, Mike Haynes, the veteran of so many years, stride for stride with him. But Thomas playing a Raider trick. For so many years, the Raiders came back to the football. Freddie Biletnikoff, as a matter of fact, the master of that particular play, is on the sideline for the Raiders today.
Kansas City, first down at their own 36-yard line. Dressel, one of the tight ends in motion. Okoye, the ball carrier, and he picks up three. Spotted at the 39-yard line. It'll be second down and seven.
Okoye is listed at 260 pounds. Said he's really about 4 pounds lighter than that. But you see a little bit of awkwardness in there, and you may see him have some trouble sustaining today because he has not practiced much, and you see him shaking his head as he comes off to the side. He's had some injury problems in his career, but when he is running at full speed with that huge bulk and 4.46 speed, under 4.5 speed, he is a load, Charlie.
And now Herman Hurd along with James Saxon into the offensive set. And here is Hurd. And he is to the 40. Maybe two, maybe one. Let's see where they spot it. It's going to be third down and in the neighborhood of six to go as Zeffley makes the tackle. Let's go back just for a moment, Merlin, to last week, the opener for the Chiefs against Denver. They were down midway in the first quarter. They were down 17 to nothing because they had a pass, first pass picked off, run back for a touchdown. The second offensive play, next time they had the ball, fumbled at the 8-yard line, Broncos went in.
A horrible start for them. I think the impressive thing for Schottenheimer and these Chiefs is that they didn't quit. They came back. And not only came back, but they were in the ball game until late in the fourth quarter.
When DeBerg was intercepted again. Third down. One out of one on third down. Conversions. He's open. And it is intercepted. An outstanding defensive play. Rob Thomas got behind the corner. The safety was lurking in the wing.
Van McElroy plays that free safety as well as anyone in football, anticipating the quarterback, and DeBerg has had trouble looking off his receivers. A streak play down the sideline, but DeBerg not able to look McElroy off. And watch McElroy coming in at the top of your picture, number 26. He is waiting for that football and makes an excellent reception. Good defensive backs look at that ball in the air and say, that's my football, not your football.
And the Raiders go to work on offense for the first time at their own 29-yard line. this is Steve Smith. And he is to the 35. He has six for the Raiders. That offensive line, the change at center, and that, of course, is that Dan Turk is starting for most part. The Raiders are backs and receivers. Schrader is the starting quarterback, even though he does have that separated left collarbone that he suffered in the game last week. They also lost Tim Brown, a knee injury. So we'll be seeing more of the three wide receivers and the four wide receivers, and that means that Steve Smith will come out, and Mike Alexander will replace him, and Marcus Allen will stay in on most of the passing downs. And it is Smith through the hole. First down, 50-yard line, gain of 14. Steve Smith has the first down. Deron Cherry makes the tackle.
Steve Smith effective as a result of, I think, people keying on Marcus Allen, looking to the outside, and Smith, who's a very underrated football player, taking advantage of some very fine blocking up front by that offensive line. And again, that means that Dan Turk, who is in there calling signals for that offensive line, doing his job here in the early going.
First down at the 50-yard line, no score. Just under 10 and a half minutes left to play, first quarter. And again, it is Steve Smith. So rather than Marcus, it has been Smith. And now let's look at the Kansas City defense. At front seven, a man to watch, the right outside linebacker, number 58, is Derek Thomas. Kansas City's number one draft choice. He's learning as he plays. Now on passing downs, the other three linebackers will come out. And Angelo Snipes, J.C. Pearson, and Danny Copeland will come in. And this is the secondary. Could be the best secondary in the National Football League. Very strong. Second and nine. Screen. Marcus Allen to the 40. Down the sidelines, and he is going to be marked out of bounds at the 24-yard line. 22 yards on the play. And it was Chris Martin who finally took him out.
Looking from the end zone, you get a feeling for this play. As you watch Marcus Allen right there, he'll just fake the block. He lets Derek Thomas, the rookie, through. And there's the screen heading down the sideline behind John Gesick, number 63. Marcus Allen runs that play so beautifully, not only the running part of it, but the selling part of it. To be a good screen back, you got to make people believe you're trying to block them. Marcus is a good actor.
First down at the Kansas City 24-yard line. And here's Marcus on a sweep to the right side. He cuts back, and he has 4 yards to the 20. There's a flag down. It is second and six. Walker Lee Ashley with the tackle.
Chiefs players pointing that it at a holding call for the Raiders, and yes, that is what it's going to be. Marcus Allen still having some trouble with that foot, but he won't complain about it, Charlie. He said he got tired last week as well, and that was his first holding game coming in from
number
the holdout.
84 offense, still first down.
Holding on Mike Dial, the tight end, still first down, the ball back at the 32.
He also told you, I know this morning, that Monday was an awful day for him.
He said last Monday that he really hurt. But he said during the week he had deep body massages, which sounds very good, as a matter
sounds
of fact.
Sounds good to me.
That's good to me. And he said he really feels good. Because last week, of course, he missed all of preseason as a holdout. Last week, the first contact that he'd had. And he was sore on Monday. Here's the draw. Slips two tackles. Now, this is a great play for Marcus, because you hear about this all the time. Any other back would have lost 2, maybe 3 yards, and he slips two tackles, gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Down in the pits, those offensive linemen trying to clear the way, but two fellows got in there a little quickly, and it's Rob McGovern who finally puts the clamps on Marcus. But his ability to avoid tackles has been one of the reasons for his great success. Mike Shanahan over there saying, hey, we thought we had us in position there for a touchdown. Now suddenly it's second, about 20 yards to go.
And Schrader comes to Marcus Allen in the right flat. 25-yard line. He's got 8 yards. Walker Lee Ashley with the tackle again.
We talked about DeBerg not looking people off. On that last play, Schrader, his eyes straight down the field to hold that secondary in place until the last second, when suddenly he turns outside and whips that ball out to Marcus Allen. That's almost a long handoff, Charlie. You can almost call that part of the running game.
Schrader, 2 of 2, 34 yards. And the Raiders now show four wide receivers as Tim Ware is in there as the fourth wide receiver. Third down and 12. Blitz. Touchdown. Schrader read the blitz. He knew that Fernandez would have single coverage, and he hit him for the score.
Mervin Fernandez in for the injured Tim Brown, and Mike Shanahan said, we're not going to have any trouble with Fernandez moving in there. He's a quality receiver. What hurts us most is not having the third and fourth receivers. Fernandez right at the top of your screen, and he just blows by Ross on the other side, and no help. Kevin Porter, who's the new face in that secondary, very late coming over for deep help on that side. And of course, Fernandez able to pick up that ball.
Gosset will hold. Jaeger will attempt the point after. Trey Junkin with the snap. And so the Raiders unable to even try the conversion. And here is a look at the snap. The ball, when it went down, it simply came out of the grasp of Gosset.
An indication of how important that holder and snapper can be.
With 7:14 time remaining in the first quarter, here is the scoring drive. Took just over 4.5 minutes. Schrader to Fernandez, a 25-yard touchdown pass.
Schrader opened the scoring last week with a 26-yard pass, and that Raider deep passing game still healthy here in the early going in Kansas City.
And Jeff Jaeger will kick off to either Kenny Gamble or Danny Copeland.
Good deep kick.
And Gamble will down it. And Kansas City will bring it out to the 20-yard line. Let's go back to the touchdown.
Charlie, Kevin Ross over here on Fernandez is taking him man-to-man. Fernandez just runs it up, and Ross expects help from Porter. Porter is watching Alexander come into here and late getting over. Watch the play develop. Porter has got to come over for deep help on Fernandez, and he is late getting over there, I think because Schrader kept him locked in with his eyes on that receiver. Good play by the Raiders. 6 points on the board.
Kansas City, second opportunity in offense. They go right back to the running game, Christian Okoye. He'll have 7 on the play. And it'll be 2nd and 3. Bob Golic. Jets in Cleveland, no score. Washington very quickly in front of the Eagles. That's a surprise, no score, Pittsburgh-Cincinnati. Dallas in front of Atlanta. Miami, look at this, quickly, 14-0 over New England.
Well, they did that last week and then folded, so Shula's talking, I'm sure, down there.
And here's our score, the Raiders 6, and the Chiefs nothing. Loses only a first down if the Chiefs retain possession, and they will. Ben McElroy, who has the interception that set up the drive for the Raiders, makes the tackle, the ball at the 33.
Howie Long did not start this game, Charlie, but he is going to play quite a bit today. That ankle of his healing enough for him to start making regular appearances. There he is at his familiar left end position. Only appeared at right end last week because he couldn't move to the inside off that ankle.
Al Davis said he'd like about 25 defensive plays from Howie in this game. Saxon, close to the first down. James Saxon. It was a first down, and it's close to 10 yards.
Saxon, a slashing kind of ball carrier, reminiscent of a Rocky Blyer. He's just a tough guy, gets everything he can get. You watch him here, some good blocking by John Ault, the big left tackle there, to give him a little bit of room. There you see that slashing style of running. Able to get down within about a half a yard of that first down.
And it's second down. Raiders lead it 6-0. And Saxon again. And he spins to Raider territory. To the Los Angeles 49, McElroy with the tackle. First down, Kansas City.
When you're making that kind of yardage on a play, you know that the offensive line is working well. The guy we're watching in there a lot today is number 53, Mike Webster, on the center. And Webby doing a job of leading Golic across the way. And of course, Saxon cutting back against the grain. A good back has to have the vision, the eyes, to let him see that hole open up on the backside.
Saxon, two carries, 18 yards rushing. Okoye back in. First down. Play action fake. Great fake. Down the sideline. As Dressel makes a move inside and scores from 49 yards out. Chris Dressel.
If the ground game, if the running game is going.
Pounding with the run, set it up with a beautiful fake, and all of the Raiders went with the run. And Nick Lowry adds the extra point. That's now 175 in a row. Chiefs on top, 7-6.
Sports coverage of the National Football League is brought to you by Michelob. One taste will tell you why the night belongs to Michelob. By Today's Chevrolet, who invites you to see why nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. And by Levi's 505 and 506 jeans.
Welcome back to Arrowhead Stadium. This is Charlie Jones along with Merlin Olsen. Scoring drive, 80 yards, five plays. And it took just over 3 minutes. A 49-yard touchdown pass to DeBerg to Chris Dressel. His eighth career touchdown, his first since joining Kansas City. Played his collegiate ball at Stanford. And now Nick Lowry to kick it off. To Bobby Joe Edmonds and through the back edge of the end zone for the touchback, and will bring it back out.
And the sun bothering Edmonds as he tried to feel it. We talked about having that sun in your eyes. Edmonds trying to look up into it here, and he has trouble. Let's go back to that play quickly. Sellout blocking by this line, and Okoye making it look like a run. But the other thing that's happening here, Jonathan Hayes leading all the way across, and Chris Dressel will just sit in there until the last second, and then he'll just drift to the outside. Play action pass. They had everyone fooled. Watch Dressel using running ability. Now down at the side, he gets pinned in. He's not going to go down. Makes a running back move and gets it into the end zone, and the Chiefs celebrate.
Offside, number 52, kicking team, re-kick, five-yard penalty.
Jerry Seaman, the referee. Angelo Snipes a bit anxious, so he was offside, so they'll move the ball back to the 30-yard line, and they will re-kick, and that'll give us an opportunity just to see the problem that Bobby Joe Edmonds and Stephon Adams have as they look up in the sun.
That sun shining right down, and that was a line drive kick. A kick that came right, well, where it should have been caught by Bobby Joe Edmonds, but Bobby Joe's got to be just a little rusty. and also seems to have trouble. In fact, Marty Schott and I were saying that in the Pro Bowl, when Bobby Joe was selected as the Pro Bowl kick returner, that before the game started over there in Honolulu, they were afraid that he wasn't going to be able to catch anything. And they actually made a choice at the kickoff of putting the sun at their backs so that the other team would have to face that. And Vai Sikahima ends up fumbling a couple of punts, ends up scoring for the AFC. They ended up winning the ball game.
Now, from the perspective of the return man,
he's got this one.
To the 20, the 25. Nice return to the 30-yard line. Costly penalty, 18 yards in the return. Costly penalty on the kickoff. Angelo Snipes, the man who was offside, Joe, made the stop at the 30-yard line, 31-yard line. So 11 yards in reality, the difference in the penalty.
Charlie, we'll also talk today about the loss of Tim Brown and what it means to this Raider team. They will feel it in the offensive department where Tim is a great receiver. They'll feel it most in the area of kick returns where they simply don't have anyone with that great speed and the ability to break those long returns.
Steve Smith and Marcus Allen are the running backs. And here's Marcus over the top. 4 yards to the 35. Second down and six. All right, mark the time. 3:39 when the first altercation broke out. This is a rivalry that goes back preseason. Actually, to about, it was the last day of July of 1960 when they met at Kezar Stadium. And it has been a heated rivalry over the years. And it continues in that mode.
Inside, you're going to watch Turk right here working on Bill Moss, the Pro Bowl center for the ASC last year. And Turk getting a handhold on Moss. You see his hand up around. Moss, furious at that, does not like being held. I'm sure came up with a few words for Turk on that last play.
This is Mueller in motion. Now he goes back to the backfield to block, and Schrader in the pocket over the middle and has the first down. Willie Gough coming back to the 45-yard line where he caught it. He needed six. He got 10. First down for Los Angeles. And again, the running back and or the threat of the running back sets up the play.
Certainly does. And we talked about the importance of Gault's speed. Gault traditionally has hurt people more on the outside than on the inside. And one of the things that Kansas City wants to do to Gault today is rough him up physically. This Kansas City defense plays a huge amount of bump and run, almost Raider football.
Schrader's shoulder is not bothering him. He is 4 of 4 for 68 yards. As pressure from the outside, still gets it off. And it is caught.
What a great catch by Steve Mueller.
Mueller. 29 yards. The defender was in a perfect position. Mueller just played the ball better than the defender did.
Actually had his arms wrapped around the defender. You can't play a receiver any better than this. I don't know how you go about staying man-to-man any better. Look where the defender is. Right there.
Kevin Porter.
Porter is right on top of him, but Mueller just works around. Watch the catch here. Just reaches around and catches the ball against Porter's back. Porter in perfect position, but the ball is caught anyway. The disadvantage of man-to-man coverage. That defensive back never knows where the ball is.
26-yard line, first down. Marcus jumps to the outside. He goes to the 20. Second down, and the hole had been closed down. He gets to the outside and still has 6 yards.
You don't draw that play up that way, but the great running backs sense the opening. They have the vision to know where the hole is. And there wasn't one inside. Marcus found one and picks up the yardage. Picks up 6. Had he gone inside as the play is drawn, would not have made much at all.
Marcus again. Couple of yards is going to be third down and 2.
We've talked a bit about Dan Turk, and I asked him, how many games have you had a chance to start at center? He said, not very many. He said, in fact, the first games I ever started at center were back in 86 when Mike Webster got hurt. Ended that Iron Man streak in Pittsburgh, and the man that went in his place, Dan Turk, then in his second year with Pittsburgh, got a chance to start four games.
And now, of course, today, Mike Webster, the starting center for Kansas City. Last week, the Raiders, so effective on third down conversions, 10 of 16. Kansas City stopped it.
They may have done.
Kevin Ross.
Charlie, the significance of that number last week on third down conversions, the Raiders were last in the NFL last year on third down conversions.
And let's see while they have the measurement. Quickly, we'll check the ticker. Washington now 20 to nothing in front of the Eagles. You saw the tie. Dallas-Atlanta tied. Miami 17 to nothing out in front. And New Orleans 14 to nothing in front of Green Bay. Those are the early games. The score here, Kansas City 7, the Raiders 6, and the measurement shows just about a yard shy. And this is the score.
You've got to wonder how much that missed extra point will play into the strategy in this ball game. Well, it obviously is having an impact here, as Shanahan would appear to be saying, we're going to go for the first down. We're not going to go for the field goal here on a fourth and one situation.
I'm surprised by that decision. You've got to go for the field goal.
Well, let's see how it plays out, Charlie. Right. I think more and more coaches in the NFL adopting a strategy that Sam Weich is probably the largest proponent of, which is to say, go for the first down, because if you convert a high percentage of those and get touchdowns out of them, you get more points in the long run than you would out of taking the field goal at every fourth down opportunity.
But if you don't, you have wasted 3 points. And now Schrader turns and calls a timeout. The crowd is into the ball game here at Arrowhead. We'll be back in a moment. Chiefs by one. We're back to Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. The Raiders have had another opportunity to decide, to talk, to mull over the fact that they should go for the field goal. They've turned against it. They have turned against it again.
Well, Charlie, I think the traditional football logic in the NFL has always been you get the chance for the sure 3 points, and basically that's a pretty sure 3 points, you take it. But that's a feeling that is changing. Mike Shanahan obviously rolling with the new people, that new rowboat that says we're going to go on for it on fourth down and take a chance here.
I guess I'm a traditionalist and you're nouveau.
Well, I didn't say that that's necessarily my philosophy. I'm a bit of a coward. I probably would have kicked the field goal.
Fourth and one. Could the game turn on this play? Marcus has it to the 14-yard line. Marcus Allen over the top, picks up the first down as we take the countdown to the end of the first quarter. The score, Kansas City 7 and Los Angeles 6. Charlie Jones, along with Merlin Olsen, you may ask, why does he have a coat on? Why he does not? Therein lies the tale.
Yesterday at practice, Marty Schottenheimer called me out. He said they had the good hands people out there, onside kick return. He said, you're going to come out and take one of these. I said, okay. They kicked a hot one to me, and I went to the turf with it, and I came up with a burn. I tell you, all those gremlins getting to me out on that field, they said, take it and dive to the turf, and I did.
Nick Lowry complimented you. He said if you hadn't, you know, you held onto the ball, hands, Olsen did it again, that if you had waited one more bounce, he was going to take a skip and would have gone underneath.
Well, Charlie, I was afraid I was going to drop that football and embarrass myself. And when I did catch it, I knew if I went down, I might hurt the elbow. I said, to heck with it. I take it to the ground.
I'll announce in pain, right? That's all. First down. Over the middle, pass is complete. Out of the backfield is Steve Davis. Excuse me, Steve Smith. I said Steve Davis. Steve Smith. Here are the first quarter statistics. And they're pretty even. Pretty even. Time of possession also. That's a reason. That's a balance of statistics in the first quarter. Steve Smith, the fullback.
I mentioned he's an underrated player, yeah. Charlie. One reason is he can do it all. He'll block for you, carry the football, and he's an excellent pass receiver as well.
Second down and three at the 7. Marcus.
Charlie, the test of that decision made by Shanahan to go for it on fourth down is obviously going to be in whether they get it into the end zone. They made the first down, but they still need to convert. If they were to fumble a ball down in this territory or come up short, then they obviously haven't gained by picking up that first down, except that it would be a much shorter field goal down here than it was earlier.
Marcus Allen has 21 yards and 8 carries. First down, goal to go. Play action. Touchdown. Trey Jenkins with his parents in the stands.
Brother Mike, a member of the Kansas City Chiefs team, and their parents obviously will celebrate that, but we have a flag on the field. Well, there's Mike right there. Officials meeting. Let's see what it is.
Flag was dropped right on the goal line.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, number 35, Los Angeles. A 5-yard penalty will be assessed on the succeeding kickoff.
Steve Smith, who had just made a fine play, makes apparently a bonehead play there, although it will not cost them the touchdown. It is after the play. It will be assessed on the kickoff. Boy, you can't lose your poise out there, Charlie.
No. It is good. And the Raiders back in front. 13-7. The brothers Junkin, Trey scoring the touchdown. Their parents, Kirk and Doris, from Belvedere, Illinois. There's his brother. They are in the stands. They said, where are you going to sit? They said, on the Kansas City side, because we could get better seats. But the brothers would not tell us where they were sitting exactly. Otherwise, we would have tried to get a shot of them on camera. But I know that they are celebrating.
Celebrating and hurting at the same time. That's a problem with having a son on each team.
There's the drive, 69 yards in 10 plays. Kenny Gamble. Gamble outside the 30. Almost broken. Just a defender away. 22 yards on the return. Let's go back to the touchdown.
Trey Junkin at the tight end position, Charlie, right here. And Walker Lee Ashley is the man who's going to try and cover it. But watch Dial, the other tight end, come inside. He'll get in the road. And as Walker Lee Ashley tries to cover this pattern, he simply can't get through the traffic. It's a pick play, Charlie, and it works to perfection. Ashley, a half a step behind, trying to get out there, and the touchdown is over his head.
Kansas City behind for the second time in the ball game. A first down on their own 33. Christian Okoye, King with the tackle.
Jeff Jaeger out of Washington, and who's going to make the tackle? I'll tell you, the kickers don't necessarily like that.
Also, he was born and raised in Kent, Washington. He's a Husky, went to the University of Washington. When he came to Southern California, he said, why does everybody ask me how I pronounce my name? Read it. It's Jaeger.
Well, he shouldn't come down to visit you then. You live in Loyola?
Because we would think that it would be Jaeger. And he drives a Jaguar.
Jaeger and a Jaguar. It's that Spanish J that gets us, but he says it's Jaeger. How would anybody think it was anything else?
Second down, play action to Bird. Lots of time. Pass is complete. Emil Harry. Harry is out of bounds at the 49-yard line. First down. Gain of 12. Flags are down. And pushing and shoving. Remember, it started earlier, and now tempers are really beginning to flare. And Marty Schottenheimer is right in the middle of it.
Livid. Schottenheimer is livid.
Yes.
They had to restrain him.
He's got his glasses off. Look out for that man when he takes his glasses off.
At that moment, he's an old linebacker.
Clear out of the room.
Unnecessary roughness. number 36 defense. First down.
It is on Jerry McDaniel.
Let's take a peek at the end of that play. McDaniel, number 36, obviously involved in it. He takes Emile Harry out of bounds, and Emile clearly out of bounds. And Marty is the first guy there. You can't allow that, he says. Well, the flag was already on the ground. The officials concurred. But I tell you, there were a lot of red shirts out there immediately.
I'm not sure I agree with that call. It's for hitting him and carrying him out of bounds. But that was all a continuing motion.
It was what happened after they were out of bounds when he slammed him to the ground, Charlie. The officials very hard on that, especially in a game that traditionally has relatively strong emotions running in it.
There's no relativity about this thing.
Right.
I do have strong emotions. Herman Hurd. And now let's go to New York City, and Bob Costas has an NFL update.
Charlie, shortly after a fake punt attempt by the Patriots, which failed and gave Miami the ball deep in New England territory, it's Dan Marino zinging one over the middle, 16 yards to Jim Jensen. Marino, who historically has had little success against the Patriots, has thrown for two touchdowns, 17-0 Miami.
And next week, Miami will be hosting the Jets.
And we will be there.
Yes. Look forward to it. They played a good game against Buffalo last week. They could be a surprise.
Loss. They said that Shula and some of his coaches had tears in the eyes. I can understand why. They had it won and lost it in the last second.
Howie Long back in on defense, and here's Okoye. Over the years, you have heard this man's name pronounced Christian Okoye. We asked him yesterday because we heard that we had been pronouncing it wrong. He says, yes, he says, everybody has. The correct pronunciation is Okoye. So hopefully from now on it will be Okoye. We're not sure if it'll do it work or not, but we're trying.
Born in Nigeria, a member of the Ibo tribe. One of the people he depends on up front, Mike Webster. Nobody in recent times has snapped the ball more than this gentleman. He's an Iron Man. Let's watch him snap it live. You're looking through the legs down in the pits as we're watching Mike Webster.
Kenny Gamble, the ball carrier, and Bill Pakel with the tackle.
They're coming up short on that play. Third and about two, and I believe we're going to see a kicker on the field.
Philadelphia is on the board. Washington has 20. Cincinnati in front of Pittsburgh. That is expected. Dallas, Atlanta getting a little closer. Miami, you heard the update a moment ago. And New Orleans still shutting out Green Bay. And here it is Los Angeles 13, Kansas City 7. From the 37-yard line, a 47-yard field goal attempt.
Is he important to this team or what?
Look at Nick Lowry. It's good from 47 yards away. And Kansas City pulls within three. Raiders 13, Chiefs 10. 10:02 left to go, first half. Nick, a lesson in persistence. At the beginning of his career, he was cut 11 times by 8 different teams. And he held out this year.
He did, Charlie, but I think a kicker is probably the only player that can sometimes benefit from not going to camp.
He is a good one. Bobby Joe Edmonds at the 5. Formerly with Seattle and then with Detroit and now with the Raiders. Rob McGovern with the tackle, 18 yards on the return.
Let me follow up on that, Charlie. I said a player that can benefit by not going to camp. I think kickers very often in camp tend to kick too much, tend to stand around too much, and their legs get weary. We have a Kansas City player down on the field. Angelo Snipes, a very valuable special teamer and a man who intercepted a pass in last week's game, and he is obviously in pain.
So we'll take a timeout. Raiders lead it 13-10. We'll be back in a moment. We're back. Angelo Snipes has now been helped over to the bench. And of course, as soon as we have a report, we will pass it on. Merlin?
You're wondering how he got hurt. Here's Angelo Snipes. Steve Strahan, the man who's going to block him right here on the left-hand side. And it looked to me like he actually just did something himself as he tried to cut to his left, because it's his leg, obviously, that's bothering him. And his legs were not twisted as he came down. The artificial turf sometimes grabs you and doesn't let that knee turn.
First down for the Raiders from their own 23-yard line. They lead by three, 13-10. Schrader looks left, goes deep right, and it is incomplete. Now, this is the first incomplete pass of the ball game. 9:47 to go in the second quarter. Schrader is now 7 of 8 for 107 yards. DeBerg, 3 of 4. But remember, the one that he missed was intercepted, so they've all been completed. Some not necessarily to the right
jersey. Yeah.
Yes.
And, Charlie, even though that pass was not complete, the message and the warning is clear to the Kansas City defense. We're not afraid to stretch you deep. Kansas City with two great cornerbacks, and Shanahan said the guys that concern me most out there are Lewis and Ross. Not only do they play you tough on the pass, but their run support is the best of any pair of cornerbacks in football.
Second and 10. Now they come back to the run, and they come back to Marcus Allen. Just outside the 30-yard line, he'll have about 8 yards on the play. A reminder to our viewers that we'll be selecting the Budweiser Most Valuable Player for today's game at the end of the football game.
Marcus Allen told me in the locker room that he probably shouldn't have played in the second half last week. He said, I really got tired, and I was ineffective in the second half. He has played a whole lot here in the first half of this ball game, and you got to believe he's getting a little tired. Well, he's getting a moment's break here as he hits the sideline.
Snipes, good news. No, it's good news, though. It's a right knee sprain. Questionable, but possibly he could return. Here's the quick out, and it is good. To Vance Mueller, and a first down. Both quarterbacks with a hot hand.
I talked to Schrader about that shoulder.
Any pain?
He's in a lot of pain, and it's his left shoulder, separation of the joint, separation of the collarbone, and you can feel it. It's jumped up on that left side. I said, will you do anything special? Will you put any padding on it, any tape? He said, no, because if I do that, I'm going to worry about it. And if I worry about it, it's going to take away from my performance.
I would think if it hurt me, it would take away from my performance.
Well, you got to learn to ignore that pain. He's doing it and doing it effectively here so far in this ball game.
First down, sweep right side. It is Marcus Allen. And Marcus will go close to the 40-yard line. Give him six. And it's second down and four. Marcus now averaging just under 3.5 yards a carry, 34 yards in 10 carries. Walker Lee Ashley makes the stop.
Marcus came up a bit upset at the end of this play. Let's see if we can understand why. I think maybe mad at himself. Figured if he could have gotten over the top, he could have made some extra yardage. That's how tough and competitive he is. He made about six. He wanted 10.
Oh, he wanted 60.
Or 60. He'll take it either way.
Second and four. Marcus again. There's nothing there. Now he goes outside. Now there. I cannot believe this. Now there's 2 yards, and there's just no way that you can get 2 yards out of that play.
Absolutely great body control by Marcus, but that's something that he is not going to do all day long. He doesn't have, right now, doesn't have the energy, doesn't have the ability to keep sustaining that. But watch him just jump outside and look at the body control there, twisting and turning to get the extra yardage. His running style, very upright, much like Akoya, but Akoya doesn't have the lateral movement, the body control, and the balance that Marcus Allen has.
He's such a pleasure to watch. Third down and two. Schrader over the middle, it is there. Trey Junkin again. 30-yard line of the Chiefs, a pickup of 28. Deron Cherry with the tackle. A first down, and again, second time in this drive, second time in the drive, Raiders have converted on third down.
When you can run the football, you can keep that defense honest, and you're going to find seams. You're going to find room downfield. Linebacker trying to follow up on that play. That's Chris Martin, number 57, trying to stay with Trey Junkin, and he just was not able to do it.
Schrader now 9 of 10, 139 yards, 2 touchdowns. Back to the ground. Steve Smith. Now let's go to New York City. Bob Costas in an update.
All right, Charlie, as the Dolphins put it to the Patriots, a bit of history. This is career touchdown pass number 200 for Dan Marino. He hits Jim Jensen from 10 yards out. He is 200 faster than anybody in history in this, his 89th career game.
Oh, thank you, Bob. Boy, we're delving into all angles today, aren't we?
We're catching them all today.
You got them. All right, they come into our net. Steve Smith.
Marty Schottenheimer came into this game as a linebacker coach, became a defensive coordinator, then a head coach. Standing next to him is Bill Cowher, who is now his defensive coach. He'll be calling the defenses today. And Charlie, these two defenses almost mirror images because Dave Adolph, who was the defensive coordinator in Cleveland last year, is now the defensive coordinator for the Raiders. But if you were standing in the two huddles, you wouldn't even understand the language. Sounds like somebody speaking Greek and somebody else speaking Russian.
And we have an example of that for you in a moment. It's really interesting. Third and three. Schrader wants to set a screen. Now he's got to go deep, and it's knocked away. Good defensive play. Horton, the intended receiver, and Chris Martin knocked it down.
Martin, the man who was there and missed the coverage on the last play. He didn't miss that one. Excellent coverage on Ethan Horton. Ethan, by the way, started his career a number one draft pick here in Kansas City, a running back then. But watch the coverage. Martin, who came here after being turned loose up in Viking country, doing a good job on that play.
It's fourth and three, and so the Raiders will go with a field goal attempt here.
Well,
39 yards.
They're not going for this one, Charlie, and I think it's the yardage that dictates here.
Definitely. Fourth and three. And it is good. Jeff Jaeger from 39 yards away. And the Raiders stretch their margin. They're back in front by six, 16 to 10.
League is brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By First Brands Corporation, makers of Crestone Advanced Formula Antifreeze. And by Anheuser-Busch, we brew our fine quality beers to be enjoyed responsibly. Remember, know when to say when.
Raiders possessions, TD, TD, field goal.
They're doing the same thing this week they did last week, just taking that ball and marching down and putting points on the board.
And they continue to convert on third down during those drives. Jaeger to kick off. Gamble and Copeland are the return men.
Good high kick. Huge hang time on that kick, and obviously no return. Boy, that's about as good a kickoff as you can get. Not only deep and into the end zone, but way up in the air.
Now, we talked about the difference in terminology. Give me some examples.
Well, Dave Adolph on the sideline calling the defenses for Cleveland, he said, I came and learned the technology or the terminology here rather than asking a whole team to change defensively. And I said, call a play for me. He said, well, a three deep zone, everybody runs it. The Raiders call it orange jet cover three. Akoya.
Akoye with a yard. Go ahead.
Go back that. Now, the Raiders would call it orange jet cover three. If you were in the Cleveland huddle or now the Kansas City huddle, it would be closed fox straight cover five. Exactly the same defense and the different numbers, totally different terminology. Adolph said, I have to carry a card because sometimes my mind clicks back to the old Cleveland terminology, and that is difficult for me. So I carry a card with all of the names on it.
I like the closed fox one better.
Closed fox sounds interesting.
It's got another card. It seems like they're having more fun in that. Okoye. We're looking at third and nine, and all of a sudden, the defense of the Raiders has clamped down on the Chiefs running game.
The big surprise, I think, of last week's opener in Los Angeles between the Raiders and the San Diego Chargers was how well this defense played. They had had a very rough preseason, and they really turned it on last week. And you're right, Charlie, the sense here, the feeling is that they're starting to put the pressure now on Kansas City's offense.
4 minutes and 12 seconds. That is the time remaining in the first half. Kansas City has converted one of three previous third down opportunities. This is third and eight from the shotgun to Bird. Just drops it back underneath the coverage. Rob Thomas goes to the close to the 30-yard line. Now, the official spotted it right there. Now, remember, this was a touchback. This was a touchback. So you don't have to measure it here. You put the ball down. If it's touching that white line, if you're touching that white line, it's a first down.
Well, yes, unless Charlie, the lines are painted crooked.
No, they won't. They should not do that. They should not use the chains here.
I think if I were on the Raider sideline, even though they said it looks like a first down, I'd make them measure it. And I think I would do the same if I were Kansas City, because they don't always point those lines exactly to the fraction. And that's what they're doing. They're going to measure it. But I think you're right. I think it's going to be short.
If it touches the white line, it's there. If it doesn't touch it, it's not. They know that. Officials know that.
You mean those lines are 10 yards apart, Charlie?
Of course they are. And now we're going to have, little drum roll, the first punt of the ball game.
Are they
going to? And they are not going to punt.
Yeah, it certainly looked like they went. Well, the Raiders gambled on a fourth down early. Now, deep in his own territory, way down in his own territory, Marty Schottenheimer. Is he going to try and run a play, or is he just going to try and draw him off sides? Sometimes the coaches will do that. Let's see.
Come off there now, boys. Come off the ball.
Quarterback sneak is there over the right side of the center. There's the snap. He did it. The Bird pulled him off with the snap count. You were right. Good call.
I don't think they were going to run a play, Charlie.
You're right.
Now, question, did he draw them off with movement or just with his voice?
Encroachment, number 74 defense, first down.
He got away with it.
Watch DeBerg's body move. Now, he's entitled to some movement. You see him bark. You see him barking those calls? Now, here, down. And that got him going. He can only get away with so much of that before they're going to call him down. 93 Townsend, I think, the man that moved. He and Pacquiao both moving in there a little bit.
That was close to drawing off. Officials could have called it. The Bob Greasy rule, I believe. He was a master of that.
That's called a hard count, Charlie.
The Bird deep. 50-yard line. Carlos Carson had it. At the 49, they're going to make the tackle just to the Kansas City side. They'll mark it the 50. It'll be 15 yards and a first down.
How very close this ball came to being knocked away or intercepted. Watch right there. The hands just about touching the ball. But Carlos Carson is the man that goes into. That's number 54, Benson, I think, that had a shot at it. But Carson, in that little gap between the linebackers and the secondary, picks up the first down.
50-yard line. Raiders on top, 16-10. Moving on the three-minute mark. Time remaining. The first half flag is down. Koye and Jackie Shipp. Koye with the ball, Shipp with the tackle. And it will go against the Chiefs.
A holding call against Kansas City.
Jets by 7. Washington continues to dominate the Eagles. That's a big surprise. And Cincinnati comfortably in front of Pittsburgh. Atlanta creeping up on Dallas. Miami still shutting out New England. And New Orleans in front of Green Bay. And as Merlin mentioned a few moments ago, we'll be in Miami next week for that Jets game. And here it is, Raiders 16 and Kansas City 10. At the 42, it'll be first down and 18. Less than 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. Play action. All alone is Jonathan Hayes. Oh, no. Hardest pass in the world to catch because you started your celebration.
Last week in Denver, James Saxon had one going into the end zone. The same kind of pass and dropped it. But you're right, Charlie, when you're out there all by yourself, is it, Gremlins? Get into your head. This is a touchdown. Hey, nobody's around. Tuck it away and go. Where am I going to move? Uh-oh, I forgot to catch the football.
What happens, you start thinking about the picture on the front page of the Kansas City Star tomorrow morning. Those things really go through a receiver's mind at that time.
Jonathan Hayes, an underrated player in this league, one of the best blocking tight ends in football, and his pass catching is improving. Well, not on that play, but it is improving, Charlie.
Second down and 18.
Too much time. Too much time. Boy, back-to-back problems. A drop pass for a big first down down in Raider territory, and now DeBerg too slow. Joe Pendry, who calls the offensive plays. There's Joe on the sideline. Of course, he came with Marty down from Cleveland. Marty brought about seven of his coaches with him. Made some fine additions here. This is a good coaching staff, and under Carl Peterson, a team that I think is going to improve drastically over the next few years. Oh, hello. One of your tickets?
Now he is involved. Now you want fan involvement? He is involved. Second and 23. Good play. And a smart call going back to Jonathan Hayes. And he gets 10, 12 yards back, 11 yards. But now he has his confidence back. And that is more important than the yardage that he got there.
I like that too, Charlie. And you're absolutely right. If he festers, if that bothers his performance later in this ball game, the way to get rid of it, get right back on the horse. And they threw it to him. He caught it, picks up enough yardage that they're now third and a little more than 10.
Kansas City with four wide receivers.
Some incredible catches so far in this game. The one by Vance Mueller earlier, and that one with Harry just getting nailed down there and still hanging on that football. Beautifully done.
Working to be the best they can be. Teammates sponsored by the U.S. Army. During the 60s, Joe Namath teamed with two of the finest receivers in AFL history. Number 83, George Sauer, worked the cracks and seams in the zone, while Don Maynard, number 13, simply blew past them. Together, they combined for over 900 catches, over 16,000 yards, and more than 100 touchdowns. Sauer's moves and Maynard's speed enhanced each other's individual talents. Together as teammates, they became the best they can be.
4 seconds left in the first half.
And we have a big first down catch. Watch Emil Harry, Eddie Hitman Anderson, number 33, right there with the ball. Hands driving in, and Harry still had the concentration. Now, the knock on Harry has been that he drops the ball a great deal. He did not drop that one.
And remember, a moment ago, it was second and 23. Back at the Kansas City 37, it's now a first down at the Raiders 33. Fresh legs. He's been out of the ball game for a few plays. Jackie Shipp makes the tackle.
Charlie, we talked at the beginning of this game about Okoye being the workhorse in this running game. That has not been the case. Okoye has been relatively ineffective. Saxon and Herman Hurd have run well, especially Saxon, who has been the slasher in this game.
Second down and 3. Outside the Raiders 26. To Okoye, and all alone in the right flat is Saxon. 8 yard line, first down, goal to go. Chiefs stop the clock with a timeout.
Again, the play action pass, and we talked about this being a ball control. Saxon, they're going to fake to Okoye here. Saxon is just going to swing out of that backfield, and because of the bite on the fake, there he goes. He's all alone out there. Linebacker simply misread the play, played the running game, and Saxon had all kinds of room to operate.
And downfield in front of Saxon was the tight end, Jonathan Hayes. 8 yard line, just outside the 8 yard line. It'll be first down and goal to go.
When I talked to Mike Shanahan early this morning, Mike said the one thing that concerned him in playing against this Kansas City team was that Kansas City's offense would gain momentum, would gain confidence. He said they've had real difficulty getting that offense going. They self-destructed last week in Denver, but he said they have a lot of talented people, and I want our defense to shut them down, not to let them get any confidence. Well, certainly the drives that they have made today, plays like that, are giving them confidence.
First down, goal to go. Almost self-destructed, but they put it back together. The machinery is working. It's good. Kansas City 17, Raiders 60.
Christian Okoye, middle of your screen, and they're going to get him right up the middle. You can see why they love this huge back with so much strength. Great block by Webster, 53 on the center. Okoye, and there's Webster making his block right there. Look how Okoye runs through that arm tackle as he'll just burst through there. You can't tackle with one arm of that man. That was Pilkel, number 71, getting an arm in there, but he is simply too powerful to take down with an arm tackle. And Charlie, the interesting thing about Okoye to me is here he really has not been a major factor so far in this ball game. But just as we said, Okoye has not been a major factor. He steps up and knocks one into the end zone.
Now, just to our right, the coach's box of the three booths down to the right, is the coach's box of the Los Angeles Raiders. Al Davis has been in during this drive, and he is very much involved in what is going on three boxes down from us.
You bet he is.
Yes.
He's a football man, was a head coach for this Raider team initially.
When we talked with Deron Cherry, he said, Al is back. He said, you can look at the films, you can tell this is an Al Davis ball club. He is back, he is involved. Oh yeah, it's been a long, I don't remember seeing him in the coach's box in a while.
The coaches remember.
Oh yeah, well they'll know. All right, here we go. Bobby Joe Edmonds, 5 yards deep, he'll down it, we'll bring it out to the 20-yard line.
We talked about a great kickoff a moment ago from Jaeger and how deep it was. Now Lowry shells the ball. I don't think I can remember when I've seen better kickoffs in a ball game
right.
From two kickers.
You're right.
Two powerful legs. Different style, and that's something we might have a chance to show you a little later. Lowry, a most unique kicker. Very tall and with a whip of a leg, but his style is a little different than most other kickers in the league.
Now remember, the Raiders took that timeout when they kind of mulled it over in the first quarter whether or not they were going to go for the field goal I think Schrader didn't like the defense. That means they have two timeouts left. 59 seconds. Time remaining, first half. There's pressure to screen over the middle, and it's there. Then looking, Marcus Allen looked as almost as if he wanted to lateral the ball. And he spins his way to the 30 and across the 30-yard line, and he has a first down.
An absolutely remarkable play from Marcus with nowhere to go, and most backs at that point would surrender. I think Marcus would gladly have lateraled the ball too, Charlie, but there was no one there. But he simply rolls out and makes some yardage out of the play. Another first down.
He's a traveling highlight film. Trigger knocked down. Chiefs go for it. Do they have it? No. Raiders retain possession.
Was that Derek Thomas? Yes, I think it was. The number one draft choice. He held out for a while, a little late coming in. starting to make his presence felt. Right hand side of your screen, number 58. And there he is, folks. He said, hey, I'm here in time to strip that ball away.
And for Kansas City, this is their first sack of the season.
Bad news for the Raiders as one of the offensive linemen is down.
It's Wisniewski.
It's the rookie.
Steve Wisniewski, number 76.
They're looking at the ankle, I believe, of Wisniewski. Wisniewski told me before the game, he said, one of the things that concerns me today is not having Mosbar in there. Because he said on every play, one of the first things I say is, help.
What do I do?
And Mosbar does give him help. But he has played well, as has Turk in relief today.
Was his name spelled correctly on his locker this week?
Yes, I think it was, Charlie. Actually, they didn't write the names on the locker. Let's look at Wisniewski and see if we can see what happened. Left-hand side of your screen, and I believe that that's Wisniewski right there, locked up with Moss. Oh, yes, there you saw it. You see him grab that foot. And I think, again, that's the turf. That's the turf. The players in the NFL basically, by and large, hate the artificial turf. It just doesn't give.
And historically, the Raiders in Oakland on grass, in the Coliseum on grass, historically, they have always played better on the real thing.
The only players that love the turf are the kickers, Charlie.
Good point. 21 seconds, time remaining. The ball back at the 20-yard line.
Draw again.
And the Chief defense now taking over. They say we've got the football. No, they say we'll take a timeout. They were pointing and waving. 14 seconds.
Looking at that scoreboard, Charlie, two events in this first half with real significance. The missed extra point, the botched extra point, the difference in this ball game right now, and the decision by the Raiders not to take the field goal, and the conversion to 7.
14 seconds, that is the time remaining in the first half. Schrader to Fernandez, 25 yards for the touchdown, to Berg to Dressel. And of course, it was on that first touchdown that the hold was bobbled by Jeff Gossett. The snap looked to us all right. Halftime, of course, Bob Costas and O.J. Simpson scores and highlights. Boomer and the Three Bears will be highlighted.
Boomer and the Three Bears.
Let's not give it away.
I've actually seen the commercial.
I have.
An excellent commercial, and they've got some outtakes. Now, that should be fun. That should be fun.
Schrader to Junkin for a touchdown. Nick Lowry with a 47-yard field goal. Jager with a 23-yard field goal. And Okoye scoring from 8 yards out. Quick rundown, bringing you up to date with 14 seconds to go in the first half. Third down. Marcus. Down at the 25-yard line. Now they're stopping the clock. Here's what's happening. I can tell you exactly what's happening. There's a fight going on is what's happening. The official is right in the middle of it. I mean, we are slugging each other, and Steve Wright has to be young because he's got his helmet off. Never take your helmet off. They're setting up a free catch. Fair catch. They're setting up off of this punt. They're going to fair catch the punt. And off of the fair catch, Nick Lowry is going to go for a long, long field goal.
That might be an NFL record if he can make it, Charlie.
Depending
on the punt. Let's see what happens here. We got a roughness call. Personal foul.
Ooh. Against Kansas City.
And, of course, that changes the whole complexion.
That changes the whole complexion. Now they'll be out of range. Because following a fair catch, it happens, what, once every 2 or 3 years. Following, and usually at the end of the first half, or the end of the ball game, following a fair catch, you then have a free kick, and that means that the defense has to stay 10 yards away.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 63, Kansas City. First down, number 63.
Very angry. I think he's been held all day long, and I think he's frustrated by that. I think he retaliated, and usually it's the second guy that gets caught.
But what he does, it is a mistake, because what he does is take away any opportunity for that long field goal that they were setting up. And the sequence was right in line for that.
Marcus Allen to the sideline, and I think we may see a Hail Mary here. And, of course, the object there would be to get an interference call if possible, because the play in the game in the half cannot end on a foul against the defense.
And you're right. Three wide receivers to the near side. Schrader has completed 10 of 12 for 148 yards and two touchdowns in the first half.
Not bad for a guy with a bad shoulder.
Has pressure. There's no time to throw. He's just getting away. Getting rid of it. Don't let him hit the shoulder. Go into the locker room. Smart move. Good defensive play by Kansas City. Interesting. Very competitive. Very close first half.
And I think Marty Schottenheimer feeling some real satisfaction at the quality of the offensive performance and the defensive performance of his team. The Raiders continuing where they left off last week.
Kansas City 17, the Raiders 16.
Sports coverage of the National Football League is brought to you by Acura, precision crafted performance exclusively at your Acura dealer. NFL halftime activities will continue after these messages from your local station.
Entire Kansas City Chiefs organization, I want to thank you loyal fans and the many corporate sponsors who helped us reach a sellout by noon Thursday. By selling all 78,000 seats early, we were able to televise this home game live. This means that more than 10 times as many Chiefs fans can watch today's game. So our thanks go to you and the many fine Kansas City corporations led by Price Chopper, who stepped forward and took us over the top.
We're back now at our studio in New York. Welcome to NFL Live. Bob Costas along with O.J. Simpson now on the pregame show. You picked the Raiders, who are slight underdogs in this game, and it's just that close.
Well, I thought the Raiders, their offensive line has been playing super football, and I really felt that they would get a little more of a pass rush on Steve DeBerg. What's happening is they miss Howie Long. Howie's playing, but he's been hurt. Howie has to get in double-figure sacks this year if the Raiders are going to be a factor in the West. But I'm sort of happy for Marty Schottenheimer. He's an old teammate of mine in Buffalo, and he may get his first win today.
You got an opinion about Howie Long and what you view as his decline as a player.
Well, a few years ago, he changed his body type. He lost about 20 pounds. He went to the cut look. I call it the Arnold Schwarzenegger look. And ever since then, he's been hurt. It's like fighters. You see a muscle-bound fighter, you say he gets hurt, he gets tired. And I don't think Howie has played the ball that he's capable of playing since he changed his body type.
All right, Juice, let's take a look at some of the scores of other games around the league. Bud Carson is trying to make it 2-0 as the new head coach of the Cleveland Browns, a rookie coach at age 58. There he is, the former Jet defensive coordinator, and leading his old teammates 14-7 as they approach halftime in this one. Ken O'Brien will be sacked by Al Baker. He's one of those Plan B free agents that Carson picked up. He picked up a lot of them to fill out the Brown roster, and the well-traveled Baker gets the sack there. It was a scoreless game early in the second quarter when O'Brien sent Roger Vick up the middle, virtually untouched, 39 yards for the go-ahead touchdown. It was 7-0. And the Jet defense got in on the act. Ron Stallworth deflecting a Kozar pass, one of four they knocked down by Bernie in the first half, but they couldn't touch a 35-yard touchdown to Webster Slaughter. The Browns also ran back an interception for a TD, and they lead, not yet halftime, few ticks left on the clock, 14-7. Kansas City in the game you're watching with the lead over the Raiders, 17-16, the margin of difference, the missed PAT after the first Raider touchdown. Washington is pummeling Philadelphia at RFK. The score there late in the second quarter, 30-14. Mark Rippon has thrown for three touchdowns, two of them to Gary Clark, including an 80-yard bomb on the first play from scrimmage, which set the tone in the game. Cincinnati at home against Pittsburgh. Boomer Esiason, 27 yards to Eddie Brown. Brown's first reception of the year goes for a touchdown. In this is return following the holdout. There is Chuck Knoll, a man who has every reason to be glum. 51-0 last week against the Browns, 20-3 at halftime in this one. Here's the play we mentioned a moment ago. It's Eddie Brown on the receiving end. He doesn't show too much rust from the holdout. Boomer Esiason with the TD toss, 20-3, and they tack on another one. On this touchdown, Icky Woods tumbles in, and he'll have to do his dance along the sideline, which he did. The Bengals lead by 17. Dallas is playing at Atlanta, and they're on the scoreboard for the first time this year. Blanked a week ago at the Superdome against the Saints. They get a touchdown pass of 65 yards from Troy Aikman to Michael Irvin. For Aikman, it's his first NFL touchdown throw, and the Cowboys lead at Atlanta 21-10. Miami over New England, 24-0, and in this game, Dan Marino has thrown three touchdown passes to reach 200 for his career. Mark Clayton returns. That gives him an extra weapon. They also have Sammy Smith, the first-round draft choice, whom they signed. And this would be Sammy Smith on his first NFL carry. He serves notice that he plans to be an impact player in the league, a 21-yard run. Now here's Marino off the shotgun. And it's Clayton making the tumbling catch in the end zone. He's coming back off an injury. He threw one to Jim Jensen a moment later. And this is Jensen again. His second touchdown reception of the first half. Marino's third touchdown throw. 200 even for his career. In this, only his 89th game. Now, to put that in perspective, it took Johnny Unitas 121 games to get to 200 touchdown passes lifetime. Fran Tarkenton's all-time NFL touchdown pass record is 342. It's way out in the distance, but Marino is young and healthy, and he has at least an outside chance to eclipse Tarkenton's seemingly unreachable mark. And New Orleans is playing at Green Bay. It's the first time the Saints have ever visited Lambeau Field, and they're roughing their hosts up, leading by a score of 24-7. The Juice and I will be back later in the day, but right now we ask you to stay with us as NFL Live halftime activities continue following these messages from your local stations. Welcome back to our studios in New York. And now, folks, in the same spirit in which television brought you the making of Gone with the Wind, it's time to take a look behind the scenes as they put together yet another film classic, this one designed to peddle some soda.
More of, because it's just one calorie.
Hey, somebody's been drinking our Diet Coke.
Yeah. And there he is.
Hey, it's the Three Bears. What's up?
Yeah.
Just for the taste of it, Diet Coke.
Now, last Sunday at Soldier Field, Boomer met up with more than Three Bears, and they weren't smiling as they were a few weeks back when they made the commercial.
What looked like the hardest part about it really was one of the simplest ones. To grab Boomer Esiason and turn him upside down and throw him out of the locker room, that was real easy for Van Horn and I. Very easy.
On a few occasions, those guys, those Bears, had the inkling to drop me on my head, I can tell you. But they were pretty good about the whole thing. And I think they'll probably take a big, deep breath and a sigh of relief that they didn't.
And there he is.
Hey, check it out. It's the Three Bears. What's up?
Get him out of here.
Down 33.
Three Bears.
Ralph from the previous.
But. And there he is.
Down 48.
Do I get a little growl from the previous day?
Down 50. Down 60.
And a little intimidation. Do I get a little growl from the previous ready? And growl.
Hey! Somebody's been drinking our Diet Coke.
Yeah. And there he is.
Oh, no, it's the Three Bears.
Yeah.
Ah! Ah! All right, guys, get out of my shower.
Boomer's fabulous.
Hey, somebody's been drinking our Diet Coke.
Yeah. And there he is.
Well, so much for Goldilocks, Esiason, and the Three Bears. I know you've done some commercial work yourself, Juice.
Yeah, you know, sometimes it can get embarrassing. A few years back, I was doing a commercial, and I had to jump a dog in a Hertz commercial, and the dog got hit to it after the first take. And every time I would run to jump him, he'd turn around and take a snap at me. So you can imagine trying to hurl a dog who's snapping at you. I got pretty high.
Now wait a minute. I hope this was a German Shepherd or a Doberman Pinscher, because even I could, you know, jump over a terrier or something.
No, it was an Afghan. You know, long snout.
Right.
Uh-huh. Yeah, trying to think about that. Hurtling over a dog.
Tell the truth. How much more dough from commercials than from playing football?
For me, it was more. Well, what they're paying them today, I would rather play football than do commercials.
We got to do a commercial now, but we'll be back with more of our coverage of the NFL here at halftime, so stay with us.
Welcome back to halftime at Arrowhead Stadium. It is still just the way it was when you left Kansas City leading by one. And Merlin, at the beginning of the telecast, you really expressed the feeling that the running game is the whole key to set up the passing attack. And
well, it
certainly has really
is
just followed your whole script, yes.
Well, I don't know if it's followed it exactly, but Marcus Allen has carried the ball 13 times in the first half. I don't know if he's going to be able to do that in the second half, but that opened the way then by hammering inside, opened the way for some brilliant long passing. And Schrader, who has had a great first half here, in fact, maybe his best half of football since the early part of 86, hit an early streaking pattern to Mervin Fernandez down the sideline, Fernandez gets away from Ross on the sideline, and there's no coverage coming over from Porter. Fernandez all alone in the end zone.
And there was a blitz coming, a defensive blitz that was coming, and he read it immediately and went to Fernandez. So now we know why, bad shoulder and all that he suffered last week, that he is back at the helm for the Raiders.
Charlie, we knew that Marcus Allen could run the football. Yeah. We weren't so sure about Christian Okoye. And the running game for the Kansas City Chiefs has really set things up for them today. And Okoye, who has carried the ball 11 times in the first half for over 40 yards, capped off a drive right there with an 8-yard touchdown run. Now, it's successful running, not just by Okoye, but also by Saxon, that has set up the play-action passing. And the impressive part of this first ball game has been the running game and the continuity of that Kansas City offense, to me.
And we have just been informed, as you were talking, that Bill Moss has been ejected from the ball game, will not play in the second half. The ejection because
he
threw his helmet.
Yeah, that means that Dan Saliamua, who's a fine nose tackle, but he is not a nose tackle that went to the Pro Bowl last year, will be in his place. But again, and if you're listening and you're a young football player, you can't lose your cool.
You cannot afford to do that. I mean, in that one moment, because now, as great a player as he is, you know, he is going to be watching in the second half.
He is useless to his team in the second half. Looking forward to this second half, we'll keep our eye on Marcus Allen, look at his ability to sustain in this second half. I think they're going to have to start pulling him out more and more in the second half. And also, can Kansas City's offense keep up the pressure? I've been very impressed, as I said, with what they have been able to do so far in this game.
And in case you don't understand about Marcus Allen, he held out during preseason, came into camp with a week before the first regular season game, and that was last week. And so the first contact, the first hitting he had was in the San Diego game last week. He's very effective in the first half, but he really got tired in the second half. And so now he faces that situation here.
I think he'll be tired in the second half here today, because some of the plays that he ran right at the end of the half were in particular long running plays that took a lot of energy out of it. Halftime statistics, both teams doing a good job of marking up first downs, rushing yards almost dead, even as are the passing yards. Turnovers. The Chiefs picking up one on that side, and the Raiders with an edge in controlling the football. But Charlie, I think the difference in this game, as we mentioned, two things: the missed extra point, otherwise it'll be 17-17. The decision by the Raiders to go for 7 and not for 3 when they were down there with a chance to kick, which turned out to put a touchdown on the board for them.
And the Raiders will have the opening opportunity of the second half. Nick Lowry, with the ball rolling off the tee, gets a second opportunity to tee it up and kick it. And here's Bobby Joe Edmonds from the 6-yard line. He's to the 15, the 20, the 25, the 30. There's Lowry waiting for him. Lowry really just kind of screened him, so he had to come back inside, and he could be picked off by Kenny Gamble. 43 yards on the return by Bobby Joe Edmonds, who made the Pro Bowl as a specialist when he was with the Seattle Seahawks.
Bobby Joe Edmonds saying, hey, who was it that said we couldn't replace Tim Brown's ability as a kick returner? Bobby Joe has always had the ability to just turn it into gear and head upfield. And Kansas City special teams made a mistake on that one. Lowry giving him a little toreador there. He said, hey, yo,
or go that way. Just shy of the 50-yard line, first down. Bobby Joe Edmonds played his collegiate ball at the University of Arkansas. Little play action fake by Schrader, has time, drops it off underneath the coverage to Steve Smith.
Charlie, might be a good time to talk about Schrader's passing difficulties. In the preseason, when he was really having all kinds of trouble, very inaccurate passing, he was having trouble throwing the football. And he said, what is wrong here? What is wrong? So he would, one of the problems he was having, he wasn't seeing the offense as well as he should have. You see right there, there's a man who's open, Willie Gault. But the other problem he was having was delivering the football accurately. We'll talk more about that.
Second down and 3, following that gain of 7. Here's Marcus. And he's got the first down to the 37-yard line.
Let's go back to that conversation about Schrader. Schrader's father, who was watching him carefully, said, I don't think you're holding that football when you're passing up as high as you used to. And Schrader went back and looked at films of early 1986, his best year, and sure enough,
he had dropped the ball down. He said it came as a result of a shoulder injury to his right shoulder, and he started to pull that ball down. It had affected the way he threw the ball. He wasn't throwing it as well. He's tried during this year to get that ball up higher, and it's helped his passing.
And the shoulder injury he has this year is to the collarbone of the left, on the left side.
On the opposite side.
The fake of the draw. Didn't fool anybody. Chris Martin. And the main man was Dan
Saliamua.
Saliamua. I knew he was going to do something. I've worked on it all night long and still couldn't get it.
I talked to you, Charlie, a moment ago. I said he is a fine young nose tackle. He has great power, great quickness. Schrader, a little play action fake, didn't fool anybody. He had to step up because of the pressure from the backside. Martin, one of the people pressuring, looked like the tackle from the other side, Leonard, or the end, Leonard Griffin on the other side. But Saliamua makes his presence felt very quickly.
Saliamua, Sweetwater High School, National City, California.
You know that area.
It's my area. Second down and 18, loss of 8. Schrader with protection, knocked away.
Oh,
good defensive play. Was that Saliamua got him again? Hey, we may not miss Bill Moss at all.
Well, I tell you, getting into the ballgame, his adrenaline is soaring at this moment. Watch the nose tackle, number 97, working right there after 68. Let's pick it up as you see him. Whoa, if we can find him here. Right in the middle of your screen. Get a chance to watch him. Saliamua driving inside, gets enough penetration, and trained as good defensive linemen are, the minute that quarterback shows the throw, the hands go up in the air. He rejected that one. That was like volleyball.
Third down and 18 at the 45. Going deep. A flag is down. Incomplete at the 2-yard line. Flag was dropped at the 38-yard line on the near side.
And if that's a penalty against this defense, that would be costly. They have played well in this first drive. Shut the Raiders down. Oh, they're saying
illegal use of the hands.
Illegal use of the hands against the defense.
Key call in the ball game, key penalty.
Illegal hands to the face. Number 29 defense. First down.
That's on Albert Lewis.
Automatic first down. Illegal use of the hands. We talked about the physical nature of these Kansas City corners. Watch Lewis in his battle with Galt. And they said they were going, right to the face. That's what they called right
good
there.
Call. Good
That's
call.
What they called. You're not allowed to put those hands to the face. The Chiefs said they were going to be physical with Galt, but you can't use that kind of technique.
First down at the 40-yard line. Automatic first down with the penalty. Steve Smith. 5 yards to the 35, second and 5, and Derek Thomas makes the tackle. Steve Smith, 6 carries, 35 yards rushing, so the rushing attack of the Raiders continues with Marcus Allen and Steve Smith. Marcus Allen, 14 carries, 47 yards. Right at the first down marker. Saliamua again. Let's check the ticker. Cleveland now by 7 at the half. Washington comfortably in front of the Eagles. Third quarter. Cincinnati continues. Pittsburgh trying to come back. Dallas and Atlanta. Dallas stretches their margin. Miami really doing a job on New England, and New Orleans likewise on Green Bay. And here it is the Raiders 16, Kansas City 17. With 11 and a half minutes to go, third quarter. The Raiders have converted half of their third down opportunities, 3 of 6. And they have 3 tight ends in this set. And they're throwing. Schrader is going to scramble for it. He's got it. And is pulled down. There's a flag down, and another flag is down, and he is pulled down. And you want to say, look out for that left shoulder. It's going to go against Kansas City because Deron Cherry's saying no.
I think it was a late hit. Looked like he was down there, and somebody piled in on the top of him.
And there was an earlier flag. There was a gain of 12 by Schrader in the first down. Now we have to sort out both flags.
One of the reasons that Al Davis wanted Schrader because of his running ability.
Holding, number 27 defense, penalty declined. Personal foul while the quarterback was sliding. Feet first, came in.
Agree. He was not sliding feet first. He was grabbed by the jersey and pulled down. That is a mistake.
You heard Cherry say he wasn't sliding.
He wasn't sliding. You've got to make the slide motion.
I think you're right, but watch. Let's watch the play. Schrader's strength gets him away from the rush. That was Thomas, the rookie in there, who misses the tackle.
No, that's not a slide.
Well,
no.
In essence, Charlie, the action looks like a slide.
But it wasn't.
The defense has to react to that.
It wasn't because the defensive player had the jersey and pulled him down and forced his feet in front of him. That's a terrible call that could cost the ball game.
We got your dander up here, sir.
Well, I just don't think this is too good a ball game to be turned on an official's call. Marcus Allen.
Chris Martin, number 57, in on the tackle. When you start throwing flags on a defense, very often they'll respond in kind with that kind of play. Charlie, let's look at the end of this. Now, if you're a defensive player and that quarterback's feet are coming toward you as he's on the ground, he is trying to slide. I disagree with you.
No.
He is trying to slide, Charlie, and his feet coming forward signal those defensive backs they've got to stay off of him.
Well, if we didn't disagree, we'd all wear the same suit, wouldn't we?
We sure would.
Second down. Incomplete. And a flag is down. And that flag came from deep in the end zone.
Walker Lee Ashley, number 84, or number 54, is covering on dial number 84.
And they're going to call offensive pass interference.
We'll have to let them sort that out, but it could well be that Dial used his hands, pushed off on the pattern.
Now it's an incomplete pass. Do you want to refuse the penalty and use
pass
up the down?
Interference. Number 84 offense, still second down.
And it was 84 Dial. Now the reason that flag was late, Charlie, if the ball is not thrown, there's no penalty on that.
Then it would be like a blocking call, right?
Dial number 84, and let's find him in there. Here he is, right here. He's the man to watch. Let's see if we can see when he comes out of here. Little delay. Whoops. Got him in the wrong spot. That was another four. That wasn't Dial. There's Dial right there. There's Dial pushing off on what on Ashley Lee. Walker. Walker Lee Ashley.
And the ball back to the 23-yard line.
Ooh.
Incomplete. Mueller, the intended receiver, and he was open, and Schrader just threw him a little bit low.
Schrader, whose accuracy was so remarkable in first half, has had a couple that have gone down low on him here in the second half.
What happens to you in halftime? Do you lose your rhythm? Do you get a little cool? Do you cool down? Do you have to warm up again? Do you have to start all over?
Some of all of the above, and I think in particular when you're injured, Charlie, because when you sit for a while, that shoulder, I'm sure, stiffened up a little bit on Schrader. He may be feeling a lot more pain here at the beginning of this second half than he did in the first half of this ballgame.
Third down and goal at the 23. To the end zone, and it is incomplete. Fernandez, the intended receiver, and Kevin the Rock Ross was the defender.
Albert Lewis has gotten an awful lot of notoriety for his play at the corner, but over the past 5 years, there aren't any quarterbacks in football who have had better consecutive seasons than number 31, Kevin the Ross. The Rock Ross. Look how physical this coverage is. He is right on top of the receiver. Goes up with him, sacrifices some height, but still gets his hand on that football.
40-yard field goal attempt by Jeff Jaeger. He is hit from 39. And it's good. And the Raiders go back in front. They lead by two. 19 to 17. We'll be back with a kickoff.
Now
National Football is brought to you by Mazda Cars and Trucks. Mazda, it just feels right. By Coors Light, pure brewed in the Rockies, the silver bullet won't slow you down. It's the right beer now. And by Road Handler Treadlock Radials at Sears, tough tires you can trust.
Welcome back to the sellout crowd at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. We have 10 minutes and 3 seconds, time remaining third quarter. The Raiders lead by 2, 19-17. Good ball game.
Certainly is, Charlie, and a lot of fuel, if you will, for people who will be dissecting this game over the next few days. Questionable calls, interesting choices on the field, and lots of football action.
Jeff Jaeger to kick off. Kenny Gamble and Danny Copeland are the deep backs. Boy, it is hot. Really, he hangs that up. Here's Copeland to the 10, 50, 18-yard line.
The height of that kick allows the coverage to get downfield, and as you see, they end up short of that 20-yard line. That's really a great kickoff.
It goes almost as high as the stadium is. It's as high as a punt.
Hang time is the key here. You see the Raiders running around there, but watch how far they get down the field before Copeland gets his hands on the football. The first man is all the way down to the 20-yard line. Now that is real hang time for a kicker.
Kansas City from their own 19-yard line, first down. Opens the action in the second half for the Chiefs offense. He has 4. It'll be second down and 6. Interesting, when we talked to DeBerg yesterday, he said that when I throw an interception, because we were talking about last week's ballgame, I always play better. Remember, he had an interception in the first half, and he played better since then.
Charlie said an early interception. It just seemed to get the adrenaline pumping. He said, I don't know why that is. Probably trying to atone for the early interception, but they were never really able to come back from that 17-point deficit that they gave up early last week.
The coach has suggested that he throw the interception in warm-up.
Yeah, I don't blame him.
Incomplete. Flag is down. That'll be pass interference against the Raiders. Jonathan Hayes, the intended receiver. And the defender was all over him.
Had his hand on him, and the official on the upfield side or the Kansas City side could not see that. The official downfield, the one who called the penalty, he had a better view because the other official was blocked by the offensive player.
We have pass interference, number 54 defense. That penalty be declined. I had personal foul, roughing the passer, number 90 defense. That'll be a first down.
Likewise, that's a big one. 15 yards. You'll see Wise right hand side of your screen, number 90, right there. Ball gone, clearly out of there. DeBerg buried. You'll get a better shot of it here. Watch him deliver the football, and there, 1-2. You've got to back off. You've got to roll off.
You're allowed to hit him if you're one step away and moving in.
The responsibility now on the defensive player. More than a step away. And you come in there and hit that quarterback, they'll throw the flag.
It's a first down at the Kansas City 38-yard line. Okoye.
Poor running there, Charlie. Yeah.
Well, he wanted to go to the outside like Marcus, and he can't get there. Townsend brought him down. Now let's check the 10-minute ticker. No change between the Cleveland and the Jets. Washington still in front, and Cincinnati still in front. Dallas and Atlanta just about the same. New England has that field goal, 24-3. And New Orleans continues to lead Green Bay. And here, it's the Raiders 19, Kansas City 17, 8.5 minutes to go in the third.
I talked about Marcus Allen being tired in the second half. Okoye is going to have those same problems. We talked about the fact he's only been practicing for 10 days. He looked tired on that last play.
Loss of a yard, second and 11. Little play action fake. Ooh, almost intercepted. Oh!
Almost a carbon
Benson
copy.
Could have had a touchdown if he could have held on to it. Going to Kenny Gamble, and well played by Benson.
Last week, Randy Robbins intercepted a pass, looked much like that pass, and carried it in to seal a fate for the Kansas City Chiefs. That, of course, in Denver. Benson having an opportunity there.
almost got his hands on that football. Boy, he touches it there. He's all the way in the end zone. Charlie, I tell you what's happening here, though. They're not running the football effectively, and the play-action passing, therefore, is not as effective.
Third down and 11. And we have jumping.
Mark Addicks, number 61, backing out of there. Let's see what they call, because we did have a defender out of there early.
Howie Long.
False start prior to the snap. Number 61 offense, still third down.
Right-hand side of your screen as you'll get a look at it. There's Addicks right there. He's the guy here working. I don't blame him. He sees Howie coming. Look how quick. Look at that rip movement by Howie. Howie does that so well.
A rip movement.
An arm under. And Howie uses that as a power move. I don't think anybody in football has a stronger arm under move from that side than Howie Long.
Third and 16. On the draw.
First down. Big.
Kenny Gamble. Beautiful fake by DeBerg. 21 yards and the first down. Surprise, surprise. Zepp Lee with the tackle.
You watched Howie using a rip technique on that last play. On this play, he's reading pass all the way. Addicks lets him in, and then Howie just didn't release and get a hand on Gamble. A little late reacting. Back and watch DeBerg, little handoff out of that shotgun. Caught the Raiders, and that's a great job of running by Kenny Gamble. What a nice job.
Good play call. First down. And here's Herman Hurd. Maybe a yard. Well, let's mark it no gain. Second down and 10. Now, we've had several injuries. Let's update you on what has happened. Wisniewski is out with a sprained ankle for the Raiders. Angelo Snipes is out with a sprained knee. Saxon, a sprained left shoulder. He is questionable, and Bill Moss was ejected for throwing his helmet. And that's the rule book call. That's automatic. There's a fine, too, involved, I'm sure.
Anytime you're ejected.
Is it an expensive fine?
I think it's $500, Charlie.
That's expensive. That's dinner for 10. Hurd alone in the right flat. Close to the first down, maybe a yard short, as Terry McDaniel makes the tackle.
This offense, by the way, much like the Cleveland offense of past years, Lindy Infante, one of the people credited with developing the offense, it's a pick-you kind of offense, a ball control offense that involves a great many short passes to the backs. And like that one, sometimes they can be most effective. Right now, DeBerg looking at converting on this third and short.
And they've converted 3 of 6 third down opportunities. Raiders lead by 2, 19-17. 6.5 time remaining third quarter. Okoye diving, and he's got it. Needed one, he got 2 to the 37 in the first down. He's an interesting runner. It seems as if you count him out, and then he goes for the touchdown from 8 yards out, and you wonder why he gets it here, and he, as big as he is, he manages to go over the top and pick up the first down.
He's as big as some of the defensive linemen in football. I mentioned earlier, at 6'1", 260 is listed weight. He says he's 254 when I talked to him yesterday. Has a 4.46 timing in a 40-yard dash.
And if you were with us in the first half, the reason that Okoye has the pads on the elbow, Merlin did not have his, but he participated in the onside kick at scrimmage yesterday.
You'll see a lot of pads on those elbows. Yeah.
Play action.
Oh, Dressel. Play by Dressel. Boy, that was a nice play by Dressel. Tom Benson had him pinned to the sideline, and Dressel just wouldn't go down. Watch the body control of Chris Dressel. He came with Marty from Cleveland this last year. He looks like he's going to be driven out of bounds by number 54, Benson. Watch him. He just keeps his balance, flips himself over backwards, and picks up an extra 3 yards. That's a fine play.
And it'll be second down and 1. 2 receptions, 58 yards, and a touchdown. Coyier, he's got the first down. He drew a crowd and he continued. We've got another flag down.
Crowd back there where Okoye was going to the ground, and there were about three Raiders. We may have a late hit or a face mask back there. No. Well, that's sad.
Holding call against Kansas City.
Sad for Kansas City anyway. A late flag coming in there. Looked like it was called almost after the tackle.
Holding, number 82 offense, still second down.
Holding on Dressel.
sometimes you get a good call and sometimes you get a bad one. Yeah. We told you how fine a play Dressel had made a moment ago. That's one that will embarrass him when he looks in the films tomorrow.
Takes the ball back to the 35 and takes away the first down.
Marty Schottenheimer said we have self-destructed, and usually it's the different people making mistakes, but that's the kind of thing he was talking about.
Second and eight. Goes to the 34, so it's going to be third down and seven.
75, Howie Long on that tackle. I sat down with Howie on Friday night. The Raiders had a little dinner, and Howie said he was eating a great big hamburger. I said, Howie, you like that hamburger? He said, yeah. He said, I tried that no meat stuff for a while, but he said, when you grow up on Twinkies and burgers, you got to eat Twinkies and burgers. He's a character.
They mark it at the 33, so it's third down and six. Four wide receivers. Third down conversion. Reasonably equal. There's pressure, has to get rid of it. There was a blitz coming from the outside, and that was Townsend.
Nobody even
picked
tried
him up
to block, yeah. Townsend.
Yes.
Obviously, either a mistake or offense out of construction, as they used to say. Because you can't just leave your quarterback there with nowhere to go. Townsend being used as an up linebacker in this situation.
And Nick Lowry is going to come up with a 51-yard field goal attempt.
Historic if he makes it, Charlie.
That's right. It will be his 18th field goal from over 50 yards. He is tied with Jan Stinnerud at 17. And he said, at this range, the goalposts narrow down. Partially blocked. And it is no good. Did he get a hand on it?
I don't know, but it sure didn't miss by much. That ball looked to be hanging up there a little.
Didn't
very
seem
close.
As if it exploded. We'll take another look when we come back. We have a timeout, and the Raiders continue to lead 19-17.
Next Sunday, the NFL is on NBC.
Last season, the Bills knocked Houston out of the playoffs. Now, Warren Moon and company seek revenge in the House of Pain.
Then, pro football's winningest team, the LA Raiders, wage war with John Elway and the Broncos. Plus regional action.
NBC football. It's a whole new ballgame.
I thought the ball had been tipped. In reality, it wasn't. He just didn't get all of it.
He didn't get quite all of it. And, of course, at this range, you've got to get that ball squarely. But notice how it comes down just right in front of the goalpost. Well, anyway, it was dead on. Believe me, had it been just a few feet further, it would have been good.
We'll show you right after this the end of it. Here's Marcus Allen from the 33 out to the 39-yard line. Gain of six. It'll be second down and four. And now here is the end of the attempt.
Notice where this ball ends up. Even though it is slightly short, you can't see from that angle, except it hits beyond the goalpost. But notice how well centered that ball straight on. A little more foot into that one, and there would have been a record broken here today.
He's got a new center, and he really likes him. We'll mention that in a moment.
New second holder, too. Huh? That's a whole new
holder. That's right. Trouble, and the Chiefs string him out. That was Derek Thomas and Kevin Ross who made the play.
Talk to Derek Thomas. He held out, came in late, but such a physical player. Had 27 sacks as a senior at Alabama and had a sack earlier in this game. You'll see him right there, 58. Notice how quickly he gets out. And Smith, who has good speed, just could not do anything except go down. And
Thomas got a hold of him. Thomas says he's still thinking out there, though, Charlie. He's not able to turn it loose with this defense yet. He'll be a force when he can.
Loss of a yard, third and five.
Draw.
From the shotgun, Marcus Allen offered the draw to the 41-yard line. And it will be fourth down, and we are going to see the first punt of the ball game.
Rather remarkable. Here we are well into that third quarter, and although there was one fake, no game has ever been played without a punt. Well, we didn't get there, but we got quite a ways into this one.
Gossett to kick. Lou Barnes is the return man. Had a couple of good returns last week.
He certainly did. Got great balance, good acceleration. Let's see if he can do something with this one. Ooh, what a great kick.
Perfect kick. You hang it up. He signaled for the crickets and he stepped away. It'll be down at the 20-yard line. And we've got a flag down. That may be only for illegal touching. It will go as a 38-yard kick. Trey Junkin was down very quickly.
Unless there was a block by Barnes after he called a fair catch, he's not allowed to block. I didn't see him block, but perhaps.
Also, it wasn't all that strong a fair catch signal either. That's what it's called. You've got to get that right hand up and wave it back and forth. And he just kind of, yes, I will, and he didn't, you know.
Well, he didn't know what to do, Charlie. That ball was up so high, he couldn't read where it was going to hit. Yeah. Marty is furious.
No, he shouldn't be. But Marty, you're wrong on that because he didn't give that clear-cut signal the way that he's supposed
to. Oh, you're going to argue with Marty now.
Of course.
Invalid fair catch signal.
That's right.
Number 80 receiving.
Maybe we can go back and look at it.
First down.
And the rule clearly states that you have to get the hand up and wave it. Let's see here. He's really undecided, doesn't know what to do, trying to figure out where that ball is going to come down. If it hits beyond the 10, he's supposed to let it go. You're right. That's exactly right, Charlie.
And a good
absolutely
call.
Absolutely right.
And a good call by the officials. And the Raiders continue to lead 19-17. The 7-yard line. Okoye, the lone back. And he carries. And he's out to about the 12. He has five. It'll be second down and five. And also, we talked about Marty Schottenheimer's reaction. He didn't give up on that reaction. He wasn't thrilled with that call, but it was a good call by the official.
Well, I think, Marty, that's such an unusual call. And Marty is saying, why in the world are you going to call that? I mean, the guy didn't try and catch it. Fair catch. But when Marty looks at the tape of this game,
he'll know.
Yeah.
Okoye, 55 yards rushing, 16 carries. The 10-minute ticker. The Jets have tied Cleveland at 14 in the third. Washington still in front, and Cincinnati still in front of Pittsburgh. Ooh, look at Atlanta. They're closing on Dallas. Miami comfortably in front, and New Orleans still leads by 10. Trotting. And here the Raiders by two. It still remains a close ball game, 19-17.
Trotting out the change to measure for the first down. And Charlie, that's good power football. That's smash football when you can start back in there and the other team basically knowing you've got to give yourself a little breathing room to be able to drive it out in two rides and get just inches short as they are of a first down. Raider defense preseason really unable to stop people, but they did it well last week, played very well last week, and they played pretty well here today.
Third down inches. This time the second back is Okoye, and he needed only a couple of inches. There's a scramble part at the bottom of the pile.
Yeah, ball was fumbled, and I believe fumbled before anyone hit the ground, Charlie. Let's see who came up with it.
Kansas City says they have it. I believe it was Mark Addix right at the bottom of the stack who got it. It was Tom Benson who was going for it for the Raiders.
That tell you, some of the greatest wars ever fought were fought at the bottom of these stacks. Okoye hit by Tom Benson, and that ball just popped loose, and down underneath, there's a battle of arms. 61 right there. Addix is the man who uncovered it. And watch, let's see if we can see where he goes. Well, no, he's a long ways away from the ball initially, but you saw the ball rolling off the backside of the pile, rolled right down to Mark Addix.
We have an injury timeout, and we'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back to Arrowhead Stadium. This is the first year that Mike Webster at center has worked with Steve DeBerg as a quarterback, and this past Wednesday they made a change in the snap.
They did, which is kind of interesting. Webster said that he had been snapping the ball in Pittsburgh for years so that the tip came back into the quarterback's hands. And of course, Terry Bradshaw, the quarterback for so many years, a big-handed quarterback who liked to put his hand at the end of the ball. Well, last week they had trouble. Webster trying to get out of there and the quarterback trying to get out of there. They missed a snap. They said they had any trouble before, but they changed to the kind of snap that brings the ball up flat, the way Webster used to center when he was at Wisconsin years and years ago.
That's
the kind of adjustment that veteran players can make. And Webster always thinking, always using his head, saying, what can I do to help my quarterback?
And there is Webster. And remember, they made that change on Wednesday. And so far, everything has worked on the exchanges in this
ballgame. Few turnovers in this game. I'll tell you, Mike Webster, a tireless worker. And there, DeBerg saying that Jonathan Hayes is still a little rusty.
No, he's saying,
oh, he can't go back.
He can't go in. He wants him out, and it'd be a charge timeout.
That's
rather
right.
Than an injury timeout.
He's the guy that they stopped play for. He's got to come out for one play, and then he can go back onto the field.
Exactly. For Kansas City, it's a first down at their own 19-yard line. 53 seconds is the time remaining in the third quarter. It's the Raiders 19 and the Chiefs 17. And we have some whistles. And the referee was checking on the sideline, and now I think he, is he going to send him back in the huddle or set the play to go? There may be a checking adjustment on the clock, and now we're ready. Play action to Okoye, and the pass is incomplete to Kenny Gamble. It'll be second and 10.
DeBerg is an interesting quarterback, Charlie. You got to like him, his experience. His record, not great. In fact, down among the bottom among active quarterbacks with more than 10 games starting experience. But he has been through all of the wars, and he's relishing this opportunity to play without a young superstar sitting in his back pocket.
The backup quarterback is Jaws, Rob Jaworski. I ask you, this is the only time he'd had a backup quarterback that was older than he was. Okoye carrying, and he continues to pound away. Has 4 to the 23. It'll be third down and 6.
I mentioned earlier that Okoye looks a bit awkward out there. Certainly did on that play. And he is, well, we have another player down on the field.
That's Kenny Gamble.
Kenny Gamble. We've already had Saxon go out of the ball game with an injury. Gamble, that would make two. There are only four running backs active on this roster. They turned Tommy Agee loose earlier.
The clock is stopped with 15 seconds left to go in the quarter. Here's the official attendance. They sold the tickets, but they didn't quite reach as many as they wanted. 71,741. That's not a bad turnout. 71,741 to sell out. 77,648 sold. So that means there are almost 8,000 no-shows, 7,900 no-shows. And so if those 7,907 are watching, Merlin and I would like to say hello to you, but you've missed a great ball game being here in person.
You certainly have. Some excellent football here today. And the papers earlier this morning here in Kansas City, they were saying the great sales success. Now up to Marty to make it a great football success. Well, so far in this game, some very fine football. Charlie, I said earlier the Raider defense had not played bad football in this game. I think it's the excellence of these two offenses today and not sloppy defense that's allowed this many points on the board early in the ballgame.
And they will just let the clock run out. Jaworski was coming over to the sideline, and I thought he's not taking himself out. No, they're just running the clock down. That is officially the end of the third quarter. Three are in the book, one to go, and the Raiders lead by two, 19-17. In the first half, Steve DeBerg completed 8 of 10 passes. Third quarter, he only hit 2 of 5. Schrader in the first half hit 10 of 13, only 1 of 4 in the third quarter. So both of the quarterbacks, their efficiency certainly dropped off in the third quarter. This is the fourth. Third down and 6 at the 23. Incomplete. Should have been caught. Naz Worthen, it was right on the money. Lionel Washington was there. The statistics to the first three quarters. They remain even.
They are pretty darn even with fractions.
Oh, yes.
And even on the scoreboard, too, as only 2 points separate these two teams as we go into this fourth quarter.
And Kelly Goodburn, his first punt. Bobby Joe Edmonds from the 36, misses one, misses another. Nice return. Good field position for the Raiders. 41 yards of the kick, a 12-yard return. Mike Junkin makes the tackle, and football heads are here.
Yeah, wait a minute, Charlie. We got flags down. We may have to see that ball kicked again.
I think the Raiders will take the return and the field position at their own 48.
No, you're right. They're just going to say, we'll take it right there.
Oh, yes.
Ineligible downfield, number 25 kicking team, penalty declined, first down.
It was Danny Copeland. As you know, when you punt, only the two outside men can release before the ball has been kicked. Offensive line for the Raiders, Roy Grave, John Giesick, Dan Turk, Steve Wright, and Bruce Wilkerson. Most part not playing because of a knee injury, and Wisniewski is out with a knee injury. And that offensive line continues to work for the Raiders. They are playing well. Good protection again. And the pass is complete on the far side to Vance Mueller. But credit those five men for giving Schrader the time to throw.
Certainly difficult for them with a change at center, a new quarterback for that offensive line, and also with Wisniewski, who's had such a fine rookie season so far. 2 of 5 replaced in there, and they have been able to play 4 games together this year. Last year, it was like a revolving door with the offensive line. So important for them to work together if they're going to be able to protect that quarterback. Charlie, you're right. They have played well in spite of their difficulties here today.
When you talked to the Kansas City defenders yesterday, they said, we'll see that offensive line in this game. When we play them later, they'll have 5 different people in there. They always do.
Not because they want to.
Schrader goes deep.
Intercepted.
Kevin Ross.
And Ross appears to be hurt. He intercepted the football, but he appears to be hurt.
That is his 18th career interception, and 6 of them have been against the Raiders.
Merlin Fernandez with a touchdown earlier on the up, and Ross says, you're not getting this one. Let's see what happens as he goes down. Oh, he tried to catch himself on that left arm, and here comes up, tries to catch him. Let's see what happens when he goes to the ground. He has the ball in the left arm. Yeah. A little wrestling going on. Fernandez saying, you're not getting away from me. But that ball hung in the air. And that's something that Schrader did in the preseason. He tended to hang the long pass. And when he does that, gives the defenders all kinds of room to go back and get it.
Kansas City first down at their own 8-yard line. They trail by 2, 19-17. There's a deep pattern. There is a grabbing of the jersey. It will be pass interference called against Los Angeles. Terry McDaniel reached out and grabbed the jersey of the receiver. Carlos Carson, the attendant receiver, go back.
Number 36.
Watch Ross after he gets up here, spins around, and goes to the ground. Well,
He's got some problems down there. We'll have to find out what it is that's bothering him.
Meanwhile, Jerry McDaniel was called for that pass interference. He just had a fistful of the jersey of Carson at the 36-yard line, and it's a first down.
That was one of those come back here, you.
Oh, yes, trying to reel him in. Yard to the 37, second down and 9. Gulick with the tackle.
This Cleveland style of defense that Kansas City is playing now puts, as the Raiders, who are playing the same style, puts an even higher percentage of man-to-man nose-up coverage in for those cornerbacks, Charlie. And we've seen a lot of it here today. You saw Ross with that kind of style on his interception. Terry McDaniel was man-on-man coverage there, unable to control his man, a penalty on that play. But these corners in these two defensive schemes, about 80% of the time, up man-to-man on those two wide receivers. And there they are again. Look how tight they are.
Dropped underneath, the coverage pass is complete. A good reception by Chris Dressel. Showing excellent hands today. He's out at the 45. He has 7. He's going to be about a yard shy of the first down, I believe. Dressel, that's his third reception for 64 yards.
Has had a big day. There he goes across. You see him, and a lot of time there working on the linebacker, getting a chance. No, not a linebacker. Zeph Lee, number 40. Strong safety. A converted running back. He's still learning this system.
Today's telecast, presented by Authority, the National Football League, intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Kansas City Chiefs and the National Football League is prohibited. This game is the property of the National Football League, the Los Angeles Raiders, and the Kansas City Chiefs. All rights reserved. And we have a timeout, and we'll be back in just a moment.
National Football League is brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer. By United Airlines, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies. And by New Keystone and Keystone Light. Bottled beer taste in a can. Wouldn't that be great?
This is Charlie Jones and Merlin Olsen. The Raiders defense going without some of their stalwarts.
They certainly are, Charlie. Over on the sideline, Scott Davis, who's their promising young pass rusher, not playing today, a leg injury. And also Jerry Robinson out with a partial tear of the groin, and they have missed him.
He's back with a cap on.
Yeah, with a cap on in the back there, cap in the glasses. Two very important players in this Raider defense not seeing action. You talk to Dave Adolph, he said, we need to have our quality players on the field. Talk about Howie Long, how he's been playing more today, but he too has been missing a lot of action. So this defense will improve when they get those key people back into the mix.
They had to restart. The 30-second clock had not started, and so they had to reset it. And that's the 30-second clock, of course, following the timeout. Otherwise, it's a 45-second clock, and there's a flag down.
Greg Townsend, up on the top of your screen, jumps offside on that play. Going to be 5 yards against the Raider defense.
And Okoye made about 5, about 4, so they'll probably take the penalty. And they'll have the first down. And while they do that, let's check the 10-minute ticker. Well, the Jets were closing on Cleveland. Cleveland now 28-17 as they fight back. Philadelphia and Washington. Look at this. Wow, Philadelphia. They're climbing back in that game against the Redskins.
Offside.
Atlanta.
Number 92.
Look at Atlanta. Atlanta's in front of Dallas. Miami still in front of New England. And New Orleans and Green Bay. And that one is getting closer. In baseball, in the National League, Montreal in the 8th inning leading the Mets 1-0. And St. Louis tied in that one. And we go quickly through these, so you have to check them at home.
Charlie, look how far Golic is off the ball, the nose tackle. Look how far back he is. You see the line of linemen? That's Golic about a yard behind.
And the left line incomplete to Herman Hurd.
Great touch on that pass, but it was dropped.
Two more baseball scores or panels. All right, in the 4th inning, Chicago leading California. Well, and we have another penalty.
Again, the Raiders.
number 92 defense for Stan.
Now, back-to-back calls for number 92, Greg Townsend.
No, 92's Emmanuel King.
Oh, all right. 90. All right, we better not do that.
They split it one on each side, didn't they? They even it out.
92 and 93. I'm looking at 92 and thinking 93. Emmanuel King, of course, in a place that Otis Wilson was in last week before he was cut for the second time by the Raiders.
First down, Kansas City, 45-yard line, Raider territory. Okoye, and he may end up with a yard, but that's going to be all. Emmanuel King is the man who made the tackle. The report on Kenny Gamble, he has a right foot injury, questionable return. Kevin Ross of the Chiefs has that left hip bruise, and he is going to try to return. That's the official report that we have from the bench.
Moving a little tenderly on the sideline.
Very tentative, isn't it? Raiders 19, Chiefs 17, 11:52 and counting. Time remaining in the ballgame. Good ball game between these two Western rivals. There's a blitz up the middle, and he goes to the hot receiver. Good read. Zepp Lee bringing down Emil Harry. Harry is the hot receiver on that blitz, and he went right to him. Harry also has to read the blitz. And the play goes to the 39.
54, Tom Benson getting through there clean. Webster looking at him, but didn't get a shot on him. And DeBerg showing you some good quarterbacking. He said, I've got to make the right decisions and throw the ball accurately. Well, he certainly did both of those things on that play. And Emil Harry, who's caught three big passes today, and one of them as good a catch as you're going to see at the receiving end of it.
Third down and four. DeBerg goes deep into double coverage, and it is incomplete.
And they're going to call a penalty over there.
Did they get the call?
Yes.
They wanted it.
Terry McDaniel again. You'll see him at the end of this play, reaches across and hangs on to the receiver. I don't think Emil Harry would have been able to catch that football, but watch the play. Watch the end of it right here. As Emil Harry tries to turn back,
number 36,
he grabs his arm. Right there.
He does. He hooks it.
Daniel hooked the arm. This official did not see it. He was blocked, but the official on the backside did and threw the flag.
And with the penalty, the ball goes to the 12-yard line. And it's first down.
Charlie, I don't think that was a smart play because I really don't believe that Emil Harry could have caught that football. But there you see the hang. He had a hold of his arm. You can't do that. And had Emil been able to turn around, at least he would have touched the ball, but I don't think he would have caught it.
The defender was playing the man and not the ball.
Well, it's man-to-man coverage.
And you'll get caught every time, though, when you do that. You got to look back to the ball to make contact.
Man-to-man, you can't hang on to his arm anyway.
Koye. 8-yard line, gain of 4. Second down and 6. Jackie Shipp and Tom Benson with the tackle.
A lot of rebuilding going on both of these teams. And of course, that Raider defense trying to rebuild that secondary. McDaniel is a first-year player. Last year, started a couple of times and then broke his leg. Back in the lineup as a starter this year. Lionel Washington on the other side has played 7 years, but has not had a lot of starting time.
Second and 6, 8-yard line. Okoye and Hurd, the running back. It's Hurd behind Okoye. Inside the 5, but just barely. We'll mark it the 5. Third down and 3.
Possible to pick up a first down without having the touchdown.
Emmanuel King with the stop. Defensively, from the defensive line, when you're in this situation, what are you looking for? What are your key? What are you keying on? Because you know the offense has a short field to work with.
Third and 3, Charlie, an option down for the offense. Even though that's a little out of the range of the run, you can't ignore the run. You've got to play it honest. If it were 3rd and 6, you could afford to play the pass down here. The defense does benefit from having a short field to cover here. That field compresses down there. Not a lot of room for DeBerg to work with. But I expect a run here. It's Hurd. It will be close to the first down.
I think he's got it, Charlie. Looked like the forward surge carried him inside that 2-yard line.
The Chiefs say they have it. The officials say, let's just make sure, and they call for the measurement. Bill Pakel at the bottom of the stack.
Hurd coming late, giving that offensive line a chance to move downfield, and they did a good job of moving those white and black jerseys out, and they do have the first down.
First down and goal to go. 2-yard line.
Joe Pendray, offensive coordinator, sending the play onto the field. Three tight ends. At least two I can see. Maybe three in there, Charlie.
You go with Okoye or you go with Hurd. Three tight ends. A power set.
Well, I guess you're going to, you know, Okoye has scored. He's such a big back, he can almost fall in there if you give him a little room. He'd be my choice here.
He's the Chiefs. And he has turned away. It'll be second down and goal to go at the one. Tom Benson leading the Raider defense.
Benson along with number 33, Eddie Anderson, in on that tackle. And that ball down to the 1-yard line. Second and 1 yard to go.
The time, 8:18 and counting. The margin, 2 points. The Raiders on their first touchdown. The holder, Jeff Gossett, bobbled. The snap did not get it down in time. They did not even get off the extra point attempt. And that 1 point continues to loom large in the outcome.
Certainly does. Schottenheimer with a choice here because the field goal will put him ahead. But he doesn't want a field goal here. He wants 7.
Okoye, touchdown.
Huge strength and bulk. He just runs over people. Eddie Anderson, number 33, finally makes a tackle, but he didn't get him wrestled down until he was about 4 yards into the end zone.
First time in his NFL career. In fact, that's the only time he started up. First time in his pro football career that he scored 2 touchdowns in 1 ballgame. Here is the extra point, and it is good. And the Chiefs now lead 24-19. And Kansas City just put together a 92-yard touchdown drive. They have the lead, and we'll be back with the kickoff. Take a little oxygen because we've got 7:51 left.
I talked about his fatigue. He's feeling it.
Lowry kicking off. Stephon Adams. Oh, and he almost comes down. Now let's go back to the touchdown.
Two excellent blocks to look for. Jonathan Hayes is going to drive his man inside. Herman Hurd going to come right in here and block on Jackie Shipp. And there's the run by Okoye, but some excellent blocking up front to clear the way.
The Raiders from their own 20-yard line. They trail by 5. 24-19. And Kerry Porter gets the call and has 4 yards. Second down and 6. And Okoye, 23 carries, a career high 70 yards, career high rushes, and a career high 2 touchdowns.
He's got to be a little bit exhausted.
But the way he's been playing, the way Marcus Allen has been playing, maybe everybody's going to want to skip preseason next year.
Well, I'm not so sure that that's a great idea. You'll get letters from the coaches on that one, Charlie. The players don't want to go to camp. You're right. They'd rather just come and play.
Second and 6.
Play action.
Good pass over 2 defenders to Fernandez, and he has 18 yards.
Rob McGovern playing in place of the injured Dino Hackett there to make the stop, but the play action held the linebackers long enough for Fernandez to get down into the secondary and gave Jay Schrader long enough time to find him. Look at that throw right over the top of the linebacker. That's 51 Junkin in there on that particular play. Mike Junkin gets a little flying time in there.
And Fernandez comes wide to the near side. First down at the Los Angeles 43. Terry Porter.
Marcus is tired. Marcus is tired, and Porter is in there trying to take some of the load off of him. But I mentioned that he was going to have trouble here in this fourth quarter, and the Raiders giving him a little break. Here he is, 32 back in there.
His totals right now about what they were last week, 17 carries, 53 yards.
52 yards, I think he ended up with last week, Charlie.
Second down. Play action.
Screen to Marcus. No.
They go to Mike Dial, the tight end.
It looked like they were trying to set up a screen to Marcus Allen.
Let's check the 10-minute ticker. Now Cleveland comfortably back in front of the Jets. Philadelphia closing in on Washington, and Cincinnati continues to lead Pittsburgh. Atlanta in front of Dallas after trailing. They were down 21-0, weren't they? Is that correct? And a final, Miami defeats New England. And in the fourth quarter, it's New Orleans in front of Green Bay. Here, 24-19. 5.5 minutes. Time remaining. Chiefs lead. Lead has changed hands 7 times. Here's Marcus. And Marcus Allen to the 40-yard line.
Marcus saying, Merlin, I'm not tired. Watch me run here. I'll tell you, he's an amazing athlete.
He truly is.
Great change of direction again. No hold inside. Martin there to take him down. The one thing that he doesn't do quite as well as he did early in his young career, though, is avoid those second and third people downfield. He now has more yardage than he had last week, and taking a needed sip of water and a quick break on the sideline.
Schrader, 14 of 21, 191 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception, play action, here's a blitz. He slides out of it, then he's dropped. Derek Thomas made the play, Neil Smith made the tackle, or got the sack.
Two pretty outstanding rushers. Right in the middle of your screen, number 58 is going to burst in from the right-hand side. Right there, number 58, Derek Thomas, number one draft pick. Even though he missed that tackle, he still held him long enough to let Neil Smith, last year's number one pick out of Nebraska, slip in underneath. A couple of impact players that are really going to help this Kansas City defense.
Third down and 15. For Kansas City. And Derek Thomas.
Look who's at the bottom of the stack again. At Alabama, he had 27 sacks in his senior year. He had a total of 52 quarterback sacks. You can see why. Great acceleration. Number 60, Rory Graves, did not have a chance. And that's the kind of combo linebacker, power linebacker, that these teams are looking for.
Now, Jeff Gossett will be kicking, and he kicks the ball high. Lou Barnes will be receiving, and that he still has a bit of a sun problem, but not as bad as earlier.
Short kick, Charlie. Oh, look out.
And takes a Kansas City bounce all the way back to the 50-yard line. The net is 12 yards.
Now that is just horrible luck. This tacky surface caught that ball. I think it came down on the 30, and he lost 20 yards on the bounce. Let's see where the ball comes down. touches right on the 30-yard line and jumps back to the 51. Now, I think the question being asked, did it touch any of the players before it got that far? I don't think so.
Officially, it is going to go in the books as a 10-yard kick. While the officials has this conference, we mentioned that one final, Miami defeated New England 24-10. Another final, the Jets defeat the Patriots by the same score, 24-10.
Now, Van McElroy is listening and pointing as if there may be a call against the Raiders. But they've got Carlos Carson out there to talk to him. Well, let's let the officials sort one. Jerry Seaman saying, I don't know what to do on this one.
We'll bring Ever. I know what to do, but let's sort out the option. Sure. Oh, yeah.
He knows what to do. One of the fine officials in the NFL, and he has control of this ball game, believe me.
We have unsportsmanlike conduct. Receiving team player had a man out of bounds, would not allow him inbound. The receiving team will retain the ball. Penalty, post possession at the foul.
Ooh, Marty, be careful.
That's a direct quote, Marty.
Be careful, Marty. Marty Schottenheimer, always emotional. His players following his lead, and believe me, that's something that happens. Teams take on the personality of a head coach, and Marty is tough, single-minded. He's angry because it looked like they were going to get the ball.
And it ends up being a 25-yard penalty.
It sure does. Big, big loss on that. Instead of being on the 49-yard line of your opponent, you're all the way back on the 25-yard line.
First and 10.
So it will be a first down. First and 10 for Kansas City on their own 25-yard line. 3:37, time remaining. Kansas City leads it 24-19. To the 30. Second and 5. Golic and Wise on the tackle.
Charlie, Mike Shanahan has really had a lot of heat in Los Angeles. A lot of criticism. In fact, there people had all kinds of rumors running around that he was going to be fired in the preseason, that he was going to be fired and replaced by Art Shell. We talked about it on our pregame show last week. I got to tell you, I have a lot of respect for Al Davis and the Raider organization. But one thing I don't like, if you hire a coach, either give him your support or fire him. And I think that's the kind of support that Mike Shanahan deserves. His team has played well last week. They played very well today.
Second and 4. Poye for the first down. Taking Jackie Schiff with him. And Van McElroy is also there. They mark it at the 36-yard line. First down. Tough opening schedules for both Kansas City and for Los Angeles. The first two games, they lose at Denver. They play the Raiders here today at San Diego, then Cincinnati, at Seattle, at the Raiders. So five of the first six are in the division. Now for the Raiders, they have that same thing. Five of their first six games, they won San Diego here today. Denver, Seattle, the Jets, Kansas City are within the division. So both of these teams have to get off to a good start. And we have coaches
back at Arrowhead Stadium. And last week, Charlie, we had a chance to do the Raider game, and we were talking about the fact that 30 years ago, the Raiders played their first game,
right?
That game against the Dallas Texans. There was only one man on the Raiders side of the line that was there, but you were there.
That's
and
right.
I said, who won the game? And you said, I don't remember. Well, something happened between then and now.
Right. Terry Allen, a young man in California that's working for a newspaper, did a little bit of research, and he sent us a photocopy of the newspaper in San Francisco. And so we can all find out that the that Oakland battle, the Texans to the wire and won 20-13. You can tell from the uniforms that it truly was 30 years ago, and that game took place in Kezar Stadium. And the starting quarterback for the Raiders was Tom Flores.
Tom Flores.
Yes.
And of course, Flores now has moved to another team in that same division, the Seattle Seahawks. So the plot thickens. Talking about this rivalry, though, they asked Marty Schottenheimer about the rivalry. He said, I don't know much about that rivalry. I've been in another division. Shanahan knows about the rivalry. He's been up at Denver. And, of course, the rivalry of the Western Division, no stranger for him.
Okoye and flags are down. But it's the rivalries that make professional football so much fun, so interesting. And you play within your division twice a year. You get to know each other. In the series, 33-22-2. And the Raiders have dominated it since they moved to Los Angeles.
I think they have.
Kansas City's been on a downswing.
Charlie, in part because
offside,
the Chiefs played
number
so well.
90 defense, still first down.
Charlie, you talked about the rivalry. Let's go back to those early beginnings. Which different cities and team names did today's two opponents once have?
Well, we know because of what we're talking about of the Dallas Texans.
Dallas Texans.
And, of course, the Raiders, they were in Oakland before. But
the other part.
The other part. The other part. The other part.
Seniors.
Oakland Seniors. That was their original name last. How long did that name last?
They had a contest, a name the team contest in Oakland. They chose Oakland Seniors. That name lasted about 48 hours. And they said, we're not going to call this team the Oakland Seniors. We're going to be the Oakland Raiders.
They gave the man two free tickets, thanked him, and sent him on his way.
They said, that's all over.
Okoye plowing for the first down. 26 carries, 86 yards, and two touchdowns.
We talked about the importance of the running game at the very top of this show. The two guys we highlighted, Okoye, and he has produced as we expected he might today. At least we knew the spotlight was on him. And, of course, Marcus Allen. I am impressed late in this game knowing that both of those players have just come back and started to practice. I'm impressed with how productive they have been in this fourth quarter.
And just as you can see, shy of the first down, it was first and five, so it'll be second down in inches. A minute 46. The margin is 5 points. The Raiders 19, Kansas City 24, and we have a final in. Atlanta defeated Dallas 27-21. That final just in.
Yesterday, in talking to the Kansas City coaches, they talked about the importance of being able to run the football in the final stages of a ball game, to run out the clock. That's something they were not able to do in the past. But right now, DeBerg and company are doing a pretty good job of eating up that clock, using that running game to keep that clock rolling.
Next week, the Raiders at Denver. Kansas City's at San Diego. The Raiders return home in 2 weeks. They'll be hosting Seattle. We've got a timeout. 1:46 left of the ball game, and we'll be back in just a moment. We're back. Let me interrupt you. That was a short commercial. 1:46. What were we really discussing? Should we let our viewers in it? We're discussing, once again, the Budweiser Most Valuable Player Award. And you got back too soon. We haven't had the vote yet. Okoye. Oh, now he was a step away from a touchdown. He almost broke it.
I think he heard we were voting.
Oh, yes. And in case you're wondering, he's one of the finalists.
Now, that's the kind of play that is frustrating for a defense. It's the kind of play you love if you're on the offensive side of the line with a lead that keeps the clock rolling. Raiders have called a timeout now, and they're chewing up the last opportunities to stop this Kansas City team.
And while we have this moment, let's check all the scores. Still in the fourth quarter. Is that still in fourth? I thought we had a final in that. I'm sorry. It's 35-24 on the fourth quarter. Washington 37, Philadelphia 20. Make a correction on that Jets score, because I thought I was given the final and I was wrong. It was my mistake. And Cincinnati comfortably in front of Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh really got their problems this year. Final, Atlanta defeats Dallas. Final, Miami wins. And final, Green Bay by one over New Orleans. There's an upset.
It certainly is.
And the games that started a little bit later, no score except for the Houston-San Diego game, and the Oilers have a field goal in that one.
If things stay the same as they are at this moment, both of these teams will be 1-1 in this early season. The teams basically will have won their home opener and pleased a large crowd here. Not such a large crowd in Los Angeles, but I think a lot of these folks will come back.
These are both contending teams in the West. These are both contending teams in the West.
Well, if there's one division you'd like to be in this year, it's the Western Division of the AFC, because it's a championship that is definitely up for grabs.
Los Angeles, last timeout.
And the Raiders just take their last timeout.
40 seconds.
And officially, we still have 1:29 as the time remaining.
Charlie, we've talked about that Raider offensive line, the fact that they have been rebuilt, and certainly we ought to do the same for this Kansas City offensive line, because they have done a great job in there today of clearing the way for Okoye and Herman Hurd and Saxon, all of whom have run well. But Irv Eatman, who last year was at left tackle, now at the right tackle position. Dave Lutz, a tackle for most of his career, in there at that right guard position. And of course, Mike Webster, great old pro. I tell you, he gives so much in there. Helps everybody, always with an eye open to do something more. And he talked to us about how difficult this season has been for him, but he is an important member of that offensive line. Mark Addix, who recovered a fumble earlier, this is a day he'll remember. And John Auld over there at that all-important left tackle position, protecting that backside for the quarterback, Steve DeBerg. And let's give them an opportunity to take a bow.
Second and 10. And now all that Kansas City has to do is let the clock run down. The Raiders are out of timeouts, and with the 45-second clock, they can take it all the way down and do it one more time.
Carl Peterson on the sideline. Basically, what they have done here in Kansas City is the same thing that was done in New Orleans. They brought in a football man and said, look, we want to rebuild this program. We're giving you all the titles. There was no question who was in charge here. But a general manager, president, and CEO. And I said, okay, I'm a believer.
That's right.
And of course, his decision was to bring in Marty Schottenheimer. The result's certainly pleasing here today.
Now we take the snap. And the game is over. They'll take the count down. Well, I'll vote for this man. I'll vote for number 35, for the Budweiser Most Valuable Player. Will you go with me?
I'll go with you on that, Charlie.
It's unanimous. Christian Okoye. 27 carries, 95 yards, and 2 touchdowns. The Budweiser Most Valuable Player, and Budweiser will make a contribution to the United Way on behalf of all of the MVPs selected in today's game. And so, Kansas City defeats Los Angeles by a score of 24-19. The lead changed hands 7 times. A great ball game, a sellout crowd. From Merlin Olsen, I'm Charlie Jones. So long from Arrowhead Stadium.